Trey Day, nigga. AK, nigga.
Here we go!
The guy is drunk, but there he goes!
We're through the roof. We are high.
Don't you! Don't you!
Don't you! Hi!
Hey, let me start introducing all the people in the Sicrati house. In the place to be, first step in no particular order, just because he's behind me.
He's your friend, he's my friend, he's everybody's friend.
Trey Day all day.
He's your friend, he's my friend, he's everybody's friend.
Oh, he's a big
friend. Your friend, he's my friend, he's everybody's friend.
Yo, this is Andrew 38.
Your friend, he's my friend, he's everybody's friend.
What's up,
your friend is my friend, he's everybody's friend.
Hi, this is Sally.
Your friend is my friend, he's everybody's friend.
It's Dr. Scumbag.
Welcome to the show. Welcome to the motherfucking show. I'm Dre Day all day, but more importantly, I'm here with a takeover. So here we go. Oh yeah.
Oh shit.
I like summer girls, and I got the Super Audio Sisters here.
Wow. I don't want that song.
You don't
to
want
be
this song?
Wow.
Here's up. I like girls with Emma Crosby and
no,
bitch.
Not
what?
It. Not it.
That's a jab. What do you mean, summer girls?
No, man. It has to be that Beyonce song, "Who Run the World," man.
Yeah.
Shit.
Let's do that.
Damn, I don't have that one on file.
You have this on file?
Which was that one?
No, I had, you have this on file?
I had this one on deck. I searched girls and this one came up right away.
No. Wow. No. You could at least hit girls. Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah,
I mean, that would have been a good one.
I'm here with the Super Audio Sisters. I got Lady Boot.
I reject this.
I got O'Sally.
Oh.
And I got Martha. How you doing, Martha?
Good.
Do you like this song?
Reminds me of childhood.
Yeah, see, that's that when I was growing up as a girl.
Jesus Christ, I get no breaks.
Nope.
No.
You're getting okay. Judged here, man.
That's all right, man. That's what I do. Heidi's here. She'd be kicking my ass right now.
Yes,
literally.
I'm pretty sure she would have.
Yeah.
And we got a super special guest. We got a 420 advocate, a friend to you, me, and everybody else. We got Alex in the place to be.
Ow!
How you doing?
Yeah,
who's your guest right here?
This is Princess.
Princess.
Hi, Princess.
Hello.
Now, is she ever going to become a queen?
Yes.
How, when we,
she has to marry a prince chihuahua and then
she becomes a queen. That's how it works. And then the queen mom has to die or some shit. Like, is that
right,
like England?
Right.
All right, I don't know how it works out. But we're here to talk 420. We're here to talk stupid stuff. And I better
vagina
stop
glitter.
That song because.
Yeah. yeah, please.
I was about to walk out.
I'm about to get no participation from the lady. If I don't stop playing that song, man.
You're going to get yelled at.
Oh, don't yell at me. Why are you guys going to be mad at me?
Because you didn't pick a good song.
Yeah.
Next time I run it by you guys. Fuck.
Yes.
God damn it.
Lady Boo.
For real, something.
Oh, my God.
Blame Lady Boo. She didn't say anything.
Nuh-uh.
She didn't even know.
That's not right.
I'm
don't
a guest
no.
here.
You see? Terrible.
I mean, I knew that was your favorite song.
Whoa.
Yes. Yes, I love girls with Abba Crosby and Finch.
No one here. Oh, I don't know. Is anybody wearing Abercrombie here?
No.
Nobody's wearing it. I don't even wear it. They don't let me in. They're like, sir, we know you can't shop here. Yeah. No, that's terrible. What does that taste like?
Like espresso beans. I thought they were raisins or something.
No.
No, they are espresso beans.
Straight espresso beans. Chocolate covered espresso beans.
I prefer all the chocolate and like half an almond.
Now, would you guys try chocolate covered grasshoppers?
What?
No.
I don't know. I'm on the
fence. Absolutely not.
No.
Right off the top of that. How about you, Alex?
Like it's a delicacy in China.
That's what I mean. Like
maybe if you cover it completely and I don't see like the figure or anything, you just give it to me and I just eat it. Yeah, I'll probably just eat it. Just tell me it's chocolate covered.
Just see a little bit of the face.
Well, I wouldn't even know. Whatever part is first, ass or face first, just cover it completely in chocolate and I won't know and just
there you
I'll
go.
Eat it.
Like,
just like this.
How about worms? Chocolate covered worms.
Supposedly they taste like chicken. Worms taste like chicken. Is that true?
Because
I mean, chickens
out.
Eat it.
I'm out.
I get it. Chickens eat it.
It's so funny. The chickens eat it, but they taste like chicken?
Apparently.
I missed it.
So the chicken likes the taste of chicken?
They eat it.
This is horrible.
This is weird.
This is horrible.
What have you guys been up so far doing this weekend?
I've been high.
You've been high?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Is it because you got high? Because you got high?
Because you got high. Da, 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 da.
Oh, no. Oh, she's high right now.
No, I've been drinking.
Lady,
Lady Boo.
Lady Boo and I had to wrestle a bear. We took her a shower.
Oh.
Oh, Hannah Banana.
She was good, though.
No, I mean, for the most part, to the dog came by, I had to hold her down.
Well, duh. Even if she wasn't taking a bath, you'd have to hold her down.
How about you, Martha? What'd you do this weekend so far? Nothing?
I went out with Sally yesterday.
Yeah.
We went to the Broad.
Yeah, the Broad, the museum. Yes. We've never been there.
Oh, that's dope.
Mm-hmm. And so what'd you guys see? Anything special?
We saw a lot of naked stuff.
Naked stuff?
We saw Michael Jackson with
a monkey. Yeah, we saw Michael Jackson with a monkey. Made out of gold.
Oh.
Yeah.
Now, was he naked?
That's a statue. No, surprisingly not. He was in a suit.
Okay.
And then we saw the balloon animal, the blue one.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
We saw that.
And then
we saw the big table and chair. Like, it makes you feel like you're small, but it's actually huge. Yeah, we saw that.
Seen those pictures.
But would you see naked, more importantly?
There were some chicks that were naked, but you couldn't really tell because of the way the art was. So
what
was
about
like,
the art? What about any dudes?
No, it was mostly women.
You're being really creepy right now.
Well, I want to know.
Except for the one dude.
You just want to know about them looking at
naked
dudes?
There was one dude.
The one that Brian was amazed by.
Me too.
Sexually explicit.
This sexually explicit, like, it was like an orgy kind of painting, but you couldn't really tell what started, what ended, but you can see the main two, and then it was like, yeah.
What the artwork,
that orgy with two people?
No, it was kind of like an orgy, but you couldn't tell who was who because there were so many legs, but you could only see the main two people, so the way it was painted.
So maybe.
It kind of like, it was kind of
like, I want to see that.
Yeah, it was nice, but like you could see the two people, but then you see like four or five legs, and we don't know if it was like, okay, different positions, or if there was actually more people in the painting because the way that everything was painted out.
Crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was crazy. Oh, and then we saw the America neon light. Is it America? Like America, and then it said America upside down.
What the hell?
Yeah.
It's because
it just says America and it just flashes. That's all it is.
Mm-hmm. How much electricity is that way?
I don't know, but it's a lot. Because, I mean, the whole place is lit up.
Oh.
At our old spot, we had a Marilyn Monroe sign that was a neon.
Oh, that's
And we plugged it in. And when I plugged it in, it made my Xbox turn off and on. It was like,
really?
Weird.
And it started making stuff trip out.
Yeah, it was actually pretty good. Like, I actually enjoyed it. Like, the art was nice itself. Just like
that sounds
certain pieces.
Super dope.
Yeah, it was actually really nice. I think I had pictures.
And not weird at all or creepy.
No, look, America.
Mm. Oh, crazy.
That's the America sign. Oh, and then here, wait.
Let me see that.
The balloon. Look, that's a huge ass motherfucking statue.
Check that out, everybody.
Oh, it was the big?
Yeah, it was an actual thing. It was like an actual display.
It's crazy. I wonder what's going to happen to that.
And then
that.
I think, like, I have the Michael Jackson one.
When ancient civilizations find that.
Yeah, like, it's a
fucking down.
Look. See, Michael Jackson.
What the fuck?
Oh. See, it's not. I was not. Yeah. Yeah, that's creepy.
How's it on?
That's creepy. Look at that. Look at that shit.
He looks like Ronald McDonald.
Yeah, but with a monkey. Yes. With a monkey.
That's so wrong.
And then remember the dude that we thought was an actual person just chilling there with the dog?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I got that one.
So yeah, see, an actual dude chilling with the dog. He had nice kicks. He had Nikes on.
Mm-hmm.
And is that real or fake?
That's fake. That's a statue. Okay. It was just there.
What the hell?
Yep. Yeah.
Some art is weird.
Yeah.
Well, art's
art. There was an explicit section of sexual whatever. It was wow.
And you went there?
Yeah.
No, like, we just walked inside and they were like paint, like, there were shadows. It's kind of like shadows, but like you can tell, like, oh, there was a woman that was like sucking on a little kid's dick, but then she was put, and then another woman shoved something up his ass that like blows air. And then there was another one where he was fucking a girl and then he was cutting off her head.
Oh my God.
And then there was another one where this little girl, it was a girl, had a penis, but a watermelon was covering it. And then there was another one where it was just, it was like fucking insane, dude. That's why I said, like, please make sure, like, this is graphic, so, like, don't have your kids in there kind of thing.
But the sign was this
big. Yeah, the small was, like, this big. Not, like, when you walk in, it was on the side. So it was like, holy shit.
Like,
you know?
In the little corner of the wall. Like, I'm going to be like, oh, okay, I can't bring my kid in here.
The
stay
kid
here.
Will.
The
kid
will. Yeah.
Did you guys see little kids up in there?
No, actually, we didn't. So that was a good thing.
So the sign works.
I guess, but I mean, no kids were there at all. Like, no kids were there at all because they have free tickets.
Would you go check out
an
exhibit like that, Alex? Would you go,
I've been dying to see the broad. There's an infinity room, and there's some cool things.
Yes, there is, but that's a separate. That's separate. So, like, when you get tickets to go inside, you can like go in there and reserve, so then you could get in because that sells out real quick. So, like, we went in. We already had our tickets because they give out free tickets. You guys should check it out. They're giving out free tickets.
No, I've signed up for tickets, like, appointments, like, 3 times already.
Yeah, so
just
it's, like...
Don't go on the appointment time.
Yeah, so it was actually really good. Yeah, so it's an actual exhibit, so you can wait right there, and then when it's your time, then they let you inside. So, but they give you, like, a small demo of the Infinity Room, so you wait in line, and you look into a circle, and it shows you, like, what it would look like. Yeah, it gives you, like, a small preview of it when you're in the museum. That's so cool. If you want to look at it, you can go downstairs and then wait and then go inside.
They get to, like, here, check this out. We're going to give you a little taste.
Yeah.
And if you like it, we'll give you more.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Because when once you go downstairs, it's, like, right there when you go inside.
That's dope.
It's pretty cool.
Has anybody ever came out of the Infinity Room and gone crazy? Like,
oh, I really don't know. My sister's been there, so I would say yes, but, you know, that's just my sister.
But she went in there like that. So.
You know, yeah, she went in there like that. She came out probably worse.
That's just her.
Yeah.
So you hear that? That was a straight-up commercial advertisement for the bra. You got to go check that shit out.
Yeah, it's fun.
Is it called the bra because it's for the chicks or what?
I wish.
Why is it called the bra?
I don't know.
It's
not on Broadway, so that was stupid. It's on Grand.
It should be called the Grand.
Right? The Grand. The Grand Museum.
It should be called the Grand.
Yeah. It should. It's right next to the concert hall.
What? Dre with the tech on deck and the weird from my beer coming out my mouth and into your ear. Let me make it clear. Talking about the dopest gear of the year and everything that I like coming in. I don't mind talking shit about the bra because that shit is dope and I want to go very far. I'm Infinity Room and I'm talking about the shrooms on the logo and I can't keep on go and I don't know where to stop. Hip hop. Somebody
almost
help me.
There. Dude,
give
almost.
Me props.
I didn't know where you were going with that.
I lost it towards the end.
Yeah.
I'm trying to.
You're still doing it.
You should have been like taking the shrooms so that I could go into the Infinity Room, you know, tripping out on lights because I'm afraid of heights, even though that's...
Where were you two minutes ago?
Well, I didn't know where you were going with this, all right? I didn't know where you were going with this.
Anywhere. You could take it anywhere.
Okay.
You could have just jumped in.
That means I need to drink more.
And I would have helped you.
So he's like, well, you could have said.
You could have said.
I got a whole verse for this, but you didn't ask me.
I just didn't. You didn't ask.
You're holding it back.
I am a lot.
She's been holding back.
I'm sorry.
We're going to give her a record deal. All right, moving on.
Sweet. Wait, no, you're kidding, right? Okay.
All right, first up is you guys like cereal, of course,
yes.
Like breakfast cereal. Oh, there you go, bust it below, go.
I can't bust anything.
Go.
I thought we were talking about cereal.
Go.
Wait,
go.
What cereal are we talking about? I was going to talk about what cereal we were talking about.
So somebody went ahead and broke them all down by flavor, by taste, by, I guess, healthiness, and by how good or bad it is for you, and this is...
So there's only like one good one, or what's the top left?
Yeah, so this is better cereal. This is worse cereal, I guess, on the healthy scale. And then
okay, so this side is the better taste, slash worse.
The taste
worse,
scale
worse,
is worse taste
better
and better taste.
Okay.
So here you guys see how you got mini wheats right here on the like.
Yeah. Like, that's worse.
Really?
Oh wow!
Wow, that's worse. Because
of the sugar, because it's frosted.
Well, yeah.
And I like the golden grams. That's not bad.
What's going on over there? How is chocolate frosted flakes?
How is Cocoa Puffs
all
fucking
the way
healthy?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, gold.
Okay,
glass?
Honeycomb is not bad. I like honeycomb.
Why
honeycomb
is Captain Crunch all the way over here? Worst taste.
Dude, I think Lucky Charms is the worst taste, bad. To be honest, because that's like fucking marshmallows right there, and they're already condensed, and then you put milk in it, and it's like, ugh.
Yeah, golden crisps are bad, too.
Cookie crisps are the shit, so those should have been better.
Lady Boo, what's your favorite cereal?
From up there?
Any cereal.
Oh,
Well, I like brand cereal, so like,
so like Raisin Bran, right just there,
regular Bran.
That's funny. It's not. Oh yeah, there's yeah, there's right Raisin Bran right there. Like,
where?
Boom, on worst taste.
Raisin Bran Crunch.
Taste. It's not that bad.
But it's better cereal.
But I'd rather have just regular brand cereal yeah. with jelly.
Okay.
Like strawberry jelly.
Oh, Sally.
Me. Okay, I prefer. Oh shit! Out of all those. Actually, I used to like the Oreo cereal that they used to have. Cereal? The Oreo cereal. What? They used to
those
have Oreo
cookies,
cereal.
Yo.
Exactly. So then I switched to Cookie Crisp for a minute. But I actually like Honeycomb.
All right. Well, where's that one at? Wait a minute.
Up there in the better slash worst column in the left.
So you're still in the worst. We're all in the worst. All right. How about you, Martha?
Applejack.
Applejack.
How's that better?
You got into the better taste. No. Yeah.
Yeah, better taste.
But worse cereal.
But worse cereal.
Alex.
Works for me.
Since it is St. Patrick's Day weekend, I'm going to pick Lucky Charms.
Lucky Charms. That's all the way in the left in the world. What's up with this goddamn map? I don't agree with anything up there.
I don't see the Lucky Charms.
It's right there, like way over there.
Oh, I see. So it's not
Fruity Pebbles are the shit.
Bad for you. Borderline bad for you, but worst taste? You know what's the worst taste? The leftover milk. That's
So did you used to drink all that milk at the end?
No,
especially with the I like the regular what's it called? Not the Frosted Flakes, just regular Corn Flakes. Yeah. I like it, but when they did the Frosted Flakes and I ate them, I was like, all that sugar's in the milk, and that just made the milk taste disgusting.
That was really?
A lot of milk.
Yes, yeah. Like I like the regular
when you're
Frosted
a little kid,
Flakes.
That's all you want.
No, dude, I'd rather eat like the fucking Fruity Pebbles or like the Captain Crunch, because then like it actually tastes good when you drink the milk.
I used to like the Cocoa Puffs or the chocolate cereal because
it would just make chocolate milk. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But no, I just like the sugar Frosted.
So you said just because it's St. Patrick's Day, but what do you used to eat when you were a kid? Which one would you usually pick?
That is, in fact, a favorite.
Oh, really?
And Frosted Flakes were a favorite.
The jam. See, all we got, though, was the cocoa, I mean, not Cocoa Puffs.
Cornflakes?
Cornflakes, yeah.
I like cornflakes, but I eat that with warm milk, though, because the way that it tastes good. Just with warm milk. Not hot, but, like, warm, and then you put the Frosted Flakes, you put the cornflakes, and it just, like, really.
And then you put, like 12 spoons of sugar in that
What
bitch.
Is wrong with you?
Yeah.
Dude, did you know that people put sugar in their Rice Krispie? I actually like Rice Krispie, but people put sugar in their Rice Krispie.
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I do.
Because they're brainwashed.
Yes. I used to put Nesquik on mine.
See, okay, but see, that's why they had the Cocoa Puff Rice Krispies, and those were bomb.
Just Nesquik milk.
Nah.
But I never thought, because I tried the sugar with that. That tastes
so when I was a
nasty.
Kid, I would even put sugar in the Frosted Flakes one.
No. Are you serious? You put more sugar in that shit?
Oh, my God, Dre. What the fuck?
Yeah.
That's too much.
Diabetes.
Yeah. Not a lot, but I would put some,
But like an extra spoon, that's not enough, bro.
Yeah.
I need more.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, no. Especially drinking the milk.
I've covered.
Because I was used to putting it in the cheap cereal all the time, like the cornflakes, and somebody had to tell me, like, yo, you don't need to put it in there. It's way sugar.
Someone had to tell you.
Yeah.
For
real.
Someone had to tell you.
Don't
put sugar in your sugar flakes.
And the Frosted Flakes and the Lucky Charms, all that.
Ew. You put them in your Lucky Charms? You put sugar in every cereal you ate?
Yes, because we had cornflakes and Cheerios and rice.
Okay, I like the Honey Nut Cheerios. That's pretty good. And I like the Honey Bunches of Oats. That's actually pretty bomb.
Guess what I put sugar in? Honey Nut.
Are you serious?
Yes,
honey Nut
and
the
Honey Nut Bunches of Oats.
Even the one
thing.
with the
Honey Cheerios?
With the clusters. We put sugar in that one.
Oh, and the Honey Nut Cheerios. And the
You're
Honey
lying.
Nut.
I'm going to move
bunches.
I did.
Bunches.
Move on.
Damn.
That's insane.
I'm gonna call my mom and I'm gonna tell her.
I'm gonna
shit, she's gonna be like, excuse me.
She would tell you. He's put sugar in everything.
Oh my God, that's like putting ketchup on everything. That's just wrong.
John, I put ketchup on everything.
Oh my God.
Hey, you know that's true.
I'm most things, not everything. Relax.
Oh, slow your roll, Drake.
Okay. Like what don't I
put? I
put
ketchup on pizza.
Oh, see, I don't do that.
I've tasted that before.
That isn't everything. You're right. You got me.
I put that. Have you ever put ketchup on mac and cheese?
No. Yeah, when there's meat involved.
Yeah.
Yeah, like hamburger helper.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
I guess that's kind of ketchup.
But I don't know why. I just put ketchup on top.
If there's not meat involved, then I don't. Pizza, I don't. I've seen people do it, but I don't do that.
It's actually good.
I'll put sauce, but I won't do ketchup. Anyway, sorry. So, John Oliver is fighting robocalls by doing his own robocalls to the FCC.
What are robocalls?
When a computer calls you up and then it does like a pre-recording or it might be AI even, and it's trying to get your information or get you to pick up
all those unknown callers you get on your phone.
So scam like the scam, those scam likely crap.
It could be a scam. It's also even like bill collectors,
telemarketers, and
or
stuff
even
like that.
Ads, telemarketers. Or even ads. Yeah.
Ads. Oh, okay. So he's fighting those calls.
Yeah, because the FCC has, because you know this guy that's Trump's fucking bitch. It's been laxing on a lot of laws and been letting a lot of other laws not go into effect. Hmm. And he's trying to fight back by having his own robocallers call the FCC, that guy.
That's funny. Like to his office? Or
to his office, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so let's check out the video.
Cool.
Maybe not the whole video because it's 17 minutes.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Plus, we'll get it taken down.
Robocalls, tied for most annoying type of phone call with every other type of phone call. Robocalls are clearly infuriating. Every one of us has answered our phone at some point to hear this.
Hi, this is Josh from the customer service department. Can you hear me okay?
It is urgent that you contact us concerning your eligibility for lowering your interest rate.
You have qualified for a free medical alert system.
Non-bailable arrest warrant issued under your...
Wow.
The
purpose
of this call is to inform you that IRS is filing lawsuit against...
That's... I get that you. One.
Wow.
It was the pause in that last one that made it a real cliffhanger. I mean, you basically knew where it was going, but there was a tantalizing chance that they were calling people to inform them that the IRS was filing lawsuit against Nicolas Cage. Which, you're assuming is always true, but a call to confirm
this
every now and then
is hilarious.
The point is, everybody is annoyed by robocalls. Hatred of them might be the only thing that everyone in America agrees on now. And if you've been feeling like you've been getting more of them recently, you're actually right. Robocalls increased by 57% in 2018 to nearly 50 billion calls.
Son
and it's understandably pissing people off.
Yeah.
The plague of robocalls is getting worse. They're the number one consumer complaint to the Federal Communications Commission, which receives more than 200,000 protests a year. Robocalls make up roughly 60% of all complaints to the FCC.
60% of all complaints to the FCC are about robocalls, so they're definitely aware of the problem. It's like the actual tea salon in Vancouver called Neverland. By this point, they definitely know they have a real issue. The only question is, what the fuck are they going to do about it?
Yeah.
The nuisance of robocalls has gotten to the point where even local news reports about them get interrupted.
We can't even get through an interview without an unwanted phone call.
I'm getting a robocall right now as we're talking.
There you go.
As I was preparing this report, I got one.
Because you are qualified for lower rate.
It is just not often that a news report gets interrupted by the subject of that report. Is your teenager getting involved in a strange new sex trend? It's called watermelony, and it involves...
That's the image that we saw on the broad.
I guess that's the thing.
Let's look at why robocalls are on the rise and what can be done about them. And let's start with a basic definition. Robocalls are...
All right, I can't play the whole video, so I really get the whole thing taken on. But check it out. But robocalls has been happening a lot lately because it's easy technology, obviously. Mm-hmm. And with VoIP, which is voice over internet, telephone, you could basically do everything. Back in the days, they used... businesses wanted to be able to call people, and when you call them back, even though they were calling from a business like a McDonald's in Kentucky, they wanted you to be able to call back to a central location, which is 1-800-McDonald's, let's say. This is just examples. So in order to do that, you have to pay a lot of money to tell the phone company to get this special type of phone line that would allow your phone to do this. And then down the line came caller ID, right? Mm-hmm. Boom. So now caller ID, people were able to see that it was 1-800-McDonald's, and they're not going to pick up anymore. So now they wanted to cover up their number, and to do this, they needed to reverse it, and it cost even more money. So now with VoIP, they could do all this easily. And not only can they do this easily from a computer, they can make 10, 15, 20 calls all at once. Mm. And it's done for cheaply. So not only our business has taken advantage of it, but also hackers. I don't know, have you guys gotten an uptick in robocalls? Or
all the time.
All the time, man. Like, they just call and it's like, dude, no. Or they'll actually still leave you a voicemail. Like, even if they call and you don't answer, they still leave you a voicemail. It's like, Or sometimes they don't leave it. They just, like, hang up. And it's like, so why are you wasting my time calling me if you're not going to leave a voicemail? And then if it's not important, then, you know.
Sometimes he'll call back, like, twice from the same number.
Mm-hmm. Twice from the same number.
Like, even if you're on the do not call list.
Yeah, like, back after back. Really? Yeah.
So
it's pretty bad, yeah.
Yeah.
I have this new feature on my phone. I have a Pixel, and it has a Google Assistant, and I'm able to do screen call. And Google will pick up the phone and be like, hello, this caller is screening his calls. And go ahead and, you know, announce what your thing is. Well, I don't know what the fuck the script is, but it'll tell me, and then it'll start reading back. A lot of times they'll hang up, and when they do that, it'll automatically put them on the do not, like on the block list, and I won't get a call. But the crazy thing is these people are able to use so many different phone numbers, and that's what trips people out. How were they able to call me from a number that's almost like mine's so quickly, so easily?
Yeah, like it's a 323 and you're like, oh, it might be somebody I know, but then sometimes they'll say scam likely or sometimes they'll say unknown. So it's like,
it's not only 323, but it'd be like the first six digits of your number, or even close, like it'd be like seven digits, and I'm like, what the fuck is this shit? You ever had that happen?
That happens on my mom's phone a lot. Like, it'll be the area code, and then it'll be the first three digits from her number, and then the last four are the complete different. And I'll be like, nope, don't even answer that.
And I'm glad you brought that up, because that's the thing I'm scared about most. I know all of us could catch it, because of older people, like my mom, my grandma, like these people that pick up the phone and don't know better. And nowadays, these hackers are being able to gather information, and they're going to call these people saying, hey, I know Andres, and he needs this, and da-da-da-da. And these people... I've heard the stories of these people actually going through with the money, and it sucks. And it's always an older person.
Yeah.
Struggle is real.
So if we ever make it big, we're going to make a foundation taking care of the old people. Make sure they don't get scammed by hacks.
That's cool.
We'll call it, you know how they're scanned for the old people? Well, ours will be scam for the old people. Check out that John Oliver video if you guys get a chance. That shit, he's dope, and that video is dope. It's 17 minutes, though. They'll fucking take us down if I play the whole thing. Next story. I'm pretty sure you know about this. Jack Hare, the father of the marijuana legalization movement, dies at the age of 70. You guys, I don't know if you guys know who this guy is. I met him once at a marijuana event in IE. It was pretty dope. He was just there chilling. I was like, damn, dude, you're like here. I seen you on the High Times cover and you're like, you're here. And he's like, hey, how's it going? And I was like, hi. I didn't know what to say. It's pretty amazing, though. And I've smoked his weed, too. He passed away.
He had a seizure, and he unfortunately was doing other drugs besides marijuana, and similar to Luke Perry, that's the rumor too, that was part of his seizure, and then he didn't quite make it after his seizure. Very similar. He had a seizure, and then he really wasn't the same. He was basically a vegetable for a while, and then
I didn't know that.
Wow.
I know he had cancer at one point, right? Didn't he fight cancer?
That I don't know, but all if right. he did, he probably did it with Rick Simpson oil. Dude, he was an amazing man. Wrote The Emperor Wears No Clothes.
Yeah.
Taught everything about the benefits of industrial hemp.
He basically laid out what marijuana legalization could look like for everybody if he did it right, and that's what everybody basically built the blocks on: medical marijuana and all that good stuff. I mean, I don't know too. I don't know. I'm a gene. I don't know everything about him, but I appreciate what he did. And like I said, him just being at the IE event, I was just like, damn, I'm walking up to you, just chilling with you.
Cool.
He was smoking too, of course. He was smoking a big ass.
He wrote the Jack Herrera Initiative, the California Cannabis Hemp Initiative, before he died. And that is the one that we were trying to get to the ballot. We're going to try again for 2020 because we don't know what this Prop 64 thing is right now.
Okay.
So we're going to try again. But
you guys are going to try to do something else in 2020? Yeah. Okay, we're going to talk about that more, of course, later. But that's awesome. It sucks that a lot of the good people we like and love, these artists and these creators, are dying, and the assholes and dickheads are still alive, like the billionaires.
Not forever.
His book is still around and worth picking up to learn what he had to say.
But when are the Koch brothers going to go?
They will. In time.
They can afford all the best health care.
Yeah. You think that young blood pumping that they do, like, you know how they put young blood, people's blood in their thing, you don't think that works?
I think to some degree, yeah.
Damn.
They said that on that science. Hold on, did I hear this from Rogan? But anyway, science has said that by 2030, they think they could reverse some age. Like they'll be able to
Benjamin Button stuff.
Like yeah, they'll be able to like.
Not exact, but I mean like, you know, he aged backwards.
I don't mean just freeze it, like pause it. I think reverse it. They're going to be able to reverse aging.
It. Wow.
Yep.
To some degree, some point, by, yep. Even if it's a little bit. That's incredible, dude. Damn. I know recently there was a breakthrough that they were able to show some way that the scientist is somewhere. I don't remember exactly. But they were able to shift time to like an eighth of a degree. But they were able to show they shift time per... What's the word? Shine time.
Whatever. Shift.
Time. I don't know. Mirror? There's a word. There's a word for it. But they were able to shift time an eighth of a second. Ugh. They were able to go backwards. Yeah.
Doc Brown. We'll have time back travel by 2028. Time travel will be available to the public by 2028.
Quote her on that.
Yes.
It's gonna be in the DeLorean. I don't know. That'd be fancy.
Check out this robot.
No, another creepo.
Oh my god. Holy shit, it did a backflip. Looks like a dog.
If I was a robot, I could do a backflip too.
Check out this fucking thing. Look at this thing. It scares the crap out of me.
Holy shit.
These things are cheap and it's very versatile.
Black Mirror, I'm telling you.
Terminator.
Yes. Have you guys seen that Black Mirror episode?
No.
No, Black Mirror?
I haven't, but I've seen all the Terminator movies, yeah. So yeah.
This is worse.
This is worse than Terminator? It's worse than Terminator. Yes. Holy
Terminator
shit.
Terminator is such a sweetheart. What the?
Nah, man. Nah. What nah. The? Uh-uh. Nope.
Burn it.
They were able to break, because the two things that people always think about robots is you could push them over easy and they cost a lot.
Yeah, because they can't.
They were able to break both of those barriers.
Holy shit. Nah, man. Mm-mm.
So, what do you guys think? By 2050, we're going to lose all our rights and we're going to be like freedomless?
We already have the goddamn sex robots and they want their own fucking thing. Didn't a sex robot say that they wanted their own freedom or some shit like that?
Oh, when? God.
Was it a sex robot?
Yeah, or something like that. Or a robot was talking like, oh.
Oh, yeah, not a sex robot.
But yeah, but a robot that wanted its own rights.
Yeah, she was getting too smart.
Yeah, exactly. So it was like, I don't know if it was a robot. Because like we talked about sex robots last time, remember, when our friend with the hat was here? He was like, there was a whole floor of different ones.
Yeah.
So I remember that. But yeah, that's why I was like, a robot wanted her own rights. And I was just like, what the fuck? I'm like, this is not Terminator shit. Like, no. But it is.
And it wouldn't be a chick robot, huh?
It would. She was a chick robot.
She
wanted
to have children.
I remember that. Yeah. I was just like, dude, you don't even have hair. And you're over here like saying you want children and this and that. I'm like, you're not even real.
That's why she said sex robot.
So it was like iRobot stuff, you know, like iRobot.
That's why Sally thought it was a sex robot. She's like, she wanted to have children.
She wants to have kids.
Yeah. Well, we talked about sex robots last time.
I'm excited for sex robots so that men can get their dick sucked for nothing in return.
See?
And I don't have to be part of that. Yeah, and I can get reciprocation perhaps from a fucking robot too.
She gets it. Y'all don't hate Dre.
Might not be that bad of an idea of sex robots for women. Like,
yeah.
Right. We haven't even thought about that.
Thank you. And we can get our own whichever celebrity we want, like celebrity wise, like if I can customize my own. Holy shit.
To say all the right things.
And then do stuff for me, like the laundry,
and
the
know
dishes.
Where your G-spot is. Oh, that's yes.
You know?
Just be quiet.
Be quiet. Massage my feet. Listen. Oh, my God.
Hey,
yes.
Man, I'm totally cool with that. As long as I get to watch, I'm cool.
The most important thing. Do all those things, but do them right.
The first time, we don't have to tell you over and over. We don't have to clean up after you and do it ourselves.
It's a robot. It's going to do it right every time.
You don't know that.
It's a robot.
You don't know
future.
That.
Sure. Looks bright.
Yeah, because if it's a man, you know what I mean? Then he's going to start thinking oh, man, I shouldn't be doing this, you know?
I'm just going to play video games. All right, check this out. I like this because...
There's toasters that will tweet.
Oh, shit,
there's,
sorry.
There's toasters that will tweet if you don't use them enough. And what? And then they'll put themselves for sale on Craigslist to find a new owner that will use them more.
What the fuck?
That fucks me up.
They'll
talk to each other like, I don't know, have you been used lately? Have you toasted anything lately?
Is that why they break down? Is that why they do the glitches and burn my toast? Is that why?
Oh my God.
Son of a bitch. It makes sense.
That would be nuts if that happened.
itself up of for Craigslist. Sale. How does it? How does it put turn itself?
It's technological,
into the
bro. It'll do it. Wi-Fi. Everything's Wi-Fi now. Everything's all Alexa, yes. Google Bluetooth. Is. Oh my God. Bluetooth. Yep.
All right, check this out. I want to get one of these devices cause, okay.
You need an endless.
You make cheese
at home.
You make cheese. You put the all the ingredients in there. You select what kind of cheese you want with the app, and then you make the cheese.
Hard and soft cheese. Vegan cheese, yogurt, tofu.
Mira. Yogurt.
Hit on me.
Milk culture. Oh, okay.
What do you guys think about this?
It makes cheese.
Yeah.
Why can't it make wine?
I don't think I need it.
I do.
Can it make pasta? That'll be dope.
I'm sure there's
something that makes pasta.
This thing will make mozzarella in 30 minutes, guys. Come on.
That's 30 minutes when I could just go and buy it?
It's like the ice cream machine.
Yeah.
Sounds like, good, but who's going to do it for real?
Yeah, when I could just go and buy it.
Yeah, leave it to the pros.
Yeah. $579.
That's my only hang up.
Nah. And it's a small little thing and it only makes it in 30 minutes. Like, if it can make multiple cheeses at a time, that would be pretty cool, but no.
No.
If I was super rich and I had my own chef, I'd be like, make me my own cheese. Chop, at
chop.
Home.
Chop, chop, motherfucker. There you go.
Here's a $600 machine.
But tofu.
Get to work.
Tofu.
That's why. Are you not listening?
Dude, hello. She was rich and she had her own butler to make it. Yes, she would pay that much money and put it in the fucking thing and make it.
The butler's got other things to
do.
Oh, chef, sorry.
I'm trying to convince her to buy it now.
No. Because are you going to do it?
No, she's
going to
do
it. Then that's why she got to get the robot.
The robot's going
to
do it.
Holy shit. He wants you to do all the... Oh, my God. No.
We're not buying that. No.
The robot's going to be for other uses, not to make my cheese.
Exactly.
That's why it's called
the dishes.
Thank you. Wash the clothes.
Check this out.
Watch these interpreters help visually impaired fans experience soccer games.
Oh.
The video surfaced on Twitter.
Showing people with visual disabilities experiencing soccer games in real time.
Look at, he's moving his hands.
And he's talking.
That's cool.
And their hands to reenact plays on a game board. To mimic the movements of players and the ball. There are also
you think they had to buy a ticket to get in there?
Blind athletes pursue
No.
The U.S. Association of Blind Athletes, or USABA, supports approximately 3,000 blind and visually impaired people nationwide. The org offers camps for sports like snowboarding, cycling, and rowing.
Wow.
That is amazing.
I like
that. That is great. Yes.
Watch these.
Awesome.
So, I like that.
So would you guys be down to go try that out? Like to watch a whole game, but just like like not watch it, like feel it?
No,
like,
that's offensive. Why?
No.
Why is that offensive?
Are you saying?
Why
are you saying
you
like if
that?
We were blind?
Yeah. No.
Would
no.
We actually
just
no.
For fun?
Just to try it? Yeah.
No. That's insulting them.
I would like to try it just because I want to see how it works.
This no.
I think that if you want to get some perspective, you need to like go blind for a couple of days. So you
God
really
damn.
Know.
I gotta go blind.
Well yes, because why are you gonna do it if you can actually see it?
I gotta
it.
Go blind just to see that shit. I just wanna try it. I wanna see what it feels like. Cause I trip out that they're like watching it and then they're feeling it like this.
But that's what I'm saying.
But
like,
you
no.
would like doing that once that you wouldn't get that experience because you don't know what it's like to be blind.
Exactly.
Just be like you would just be like
I would just want to get that experience.
No,
you're wrong. You're insensitive.
I gotta get the whole blind experience. I
gotta
go blind.
You heard it from the sisters, bro. No. That's it.
Yeah,
you are declined.
Okay.
And,
no.
Goddamn. All right.
Rude.
People like, that's why we need ADA laws. Because
Go, Susie.
I don't get it.
Rude.
We'll be right back.
There you go.
Daddy all day. Super Audio Sisters. Alex. We'll be right back.
I wanna really, really wanna zig-a-zig. make it last forever. Friendship never ends. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to give. Taking is too easy, but that's the way it is. What you think about that? Now you know how I feel. Say you can handle my love. Are you for real?
Are you for real?
I won't be hasty. I'll give you a try. If you really bug me, then I'll say goodbye. Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want.
So tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
I wanna really, really, really wanna zip a zip.
If you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Make it last forever. Friendship never ends. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to give. Taking is too easy, but that's the way it is.
So here's a story from A to Z. You wanna get with me, you gotta listen carefully. We got M in the place, who likes it in your face. You got G like MC, who likes it on a easy V. Who doesn't come for free, she's a real lady. And as for me, how you'll see. Slam your body down and wine, it's all around. Slam your body down.
If you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Make it last forever. Friendship never ends. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to give. Taking is too easy, but that's the way it is. If you wanna be my lover,
you gotta
make it last forever.
Slam
your body down
the wine,
it's all around. Slam your body down the wine, it's all around. If you wanna be my lover.
Shout out Dre Day all day. Since it's $2, can I get a shout out for Super Audio Network 2? Sure, shout out Super Audio Network. I don't know what that is. I have no idea.
Hey, but Super there you go. Audio Network, shout out.
You know what it is. It's Dre Day all day. Talking offensively about blind people, apparently.
Oh, rude. They might have robotic eyes for blind people in the future in like 10, 20 years.
Yeah, I'm sure there's.
Then can I do it?
No.
That means your eye sockets have to be pulled out, bro.
Fuck, man.
If you pull your eye sockets out, yeah, I'll give it to you.
There God you damn, go. Approval. Boom.
Can I just burn my eye? Because I got green eyes and my mom will kill me if I lose these. So can I just like burn them?
Just stare into the sun and then.
Yeah, good. Exactly. It, can I just burn them instead?
Just like blow some glass and just like.
Do whatever you want to achieve your blind dream of experiencing
soccer for blind people. All right, back to the weird for my beard. Here's some stories I think you guys will like. I have no idea, judging by the last stories. Here we go. So this device we're here is a floating device, and it lets you know if somebody is drowning.
Lifeguard, you're supposed to be doing your job.
On your phone, it alerts you. What happens if you're away from your phone?
It's like a personal pool one.
I see.
What do you guys think about this? Is this cool?
No. I guess
so. Then that'd be a waste of people. And then if it's on your phone, shouldn't you be watching your child or whoever?
That's what I was about to say.
You know, like,
yeah, I think.
You think it's Uncle Sam, big brother trying to watch you in your pool?
Yes.
No, I think it's helpful for people with kids at home that have a pool. Like if it's a personal one, yeah.
Yeah, but if it's like an actual like spa place or like a hotel, it's like, dude, I mean, there's a bunch of people and there should be a lifeguard there because that's why you pay for it. But if it's your own personal pool, then yes, I understand that.
You could put a fence around your pool, too.
That, too, yes. Mm-hmm.
But how much is a fence?
Doesn't matter. Yes. If you got the pool and you're paying for it, might as well pay for the damn fence.
And how much is this thing?
I don't know.
$1,000, it's
yeah.
in.
Yeah,
$1,000 is probably worth the fence or half than that. And you get to put it yourself.
You got to put a fence in yourself? All right.
Well, I mean, if you do it yourself or you pay someone or when you get the robot, just let me know and I'll come over.
You can always just go to Home Depot. And
that, too.
No, I already asked those Mexicans, and they charge a lot less. That means a lot more than you think.
Then get the robot.
Yeah.
That's what we need is a robot.
Yeah.
There we go. How about this one? You guys ready for the 5G?
No, what's that?
5G.
I thought it gave you
cancer or something.
It might.
What's 5G?
And it does kill some birds, but you got to get that quick data.
What's 5G?
I don't know.
5G is the next generation of internet. It's going to be wireless internet. I should say wireless data. It's going to connect everything, and you're going to be able to download, upload quicker. You're going to be able to handle larger loads, and it's going to be able to cover more areas easier. So everybody's going to be able to have unlimited. So it's going to be the future of tech. All the connected devices, all the self-driving cars, all the, like, they're even going to be able to do surgeries from across the world because this thing's going to be that quick and that efficient.
Wow, I've never heard of that before.
No.
Also, no. China and America are fighting it out for 5G because whoever gets there first will control the future.
Oh.
They say 5G is going to completely change our lives. From as simple as gaming to driving to as complex as medical care. This shift will be a once in a decade upgrade for our wireless systems. Now, that all sounds great, but what is it? And when can I get it?
Isn't that what you said?
Well, there's a brand new second generation cellular module from the current leading chip company, Qualcomm, that boasts the almighty power of 5G speeds for your phone. Except we all don't exactly have 5G phones yet, nor a 5G mobile network. However, this might be the year all of that changes. Yep. If you're just being brought up to speed, 5G is known as the fifth generation of wireless network communication. Mm-hmm. Every time the technical rules that define the inner workings of cellular networks changes, we get a new generation, or G, of technology. Meaning to reap the benefits, people will have to buy whole new phones. Wow. And carriers will need to install new transmission equipment to deliver the speeds they promised.
When and that's why the 1G, birds are dying.
It was for voice calls
that's
only.
Fucked up.
But then 2G gave us text messages. 3G added that multimedia support that we can't imagine being without, like vid chats and faster speeds. And now we have 4G, which has all the features of 3G, but an added bump of speeds from 14 megabits per second to 100 megabits per second, which changed the game. Now we have video chats in HD, HD mobile TV, and live streamed apps. But this next one is gonna be big. 5G is anticipated to give users the fastest connectivity they've ever experienced.
Watch this shit.
It's thought to be so fast, it'd compete with our current fiber optic cables in our homes. And about 10 to 100 times faster than the phone you currently have in your hand.
Yes.
But other than the major benefits of downloading 8K videos in seconds,
we're gonna go to the future with
VR and AR seamlessly.
5G. Good. But they are causing headaches.
By buffering.
And they are causing birds to die.
Well, 5G connectivity promises reduced latency or lag time to practically zero, meaning devices can communicate with each other
virtual
in
virtual reality devices are going to be
We're
able to work faster.
About major improvements in the responsiveness in devices that use sensors to make important decisions, like self-driving cars that need to suddenly brake, or industrial robots that can be sent to hazardous areas and be controlled remotely from anywhere in the world, or better yet, anything in the healthcare field. From telemedicine, precision surgical robots, to remote surgery, or even virtual
physical therapy. Are you guys down with remote surgery?
Data
slowdown.
I don't know,
but wait,
man.
How does any of this work?
How about remote gynecological stuff?
Exchanges between cell sites and devices are made with encoded data from radio waves.
Stop, Dre.
This encoding isn't much different from what 4G LTE uses. But the frequencies they use within the spectrum are. Right now, the low band spectrum that 4G LTE travels on is overly crowded.
Yeah.
And therefore, we can expect speeds up to 2 gigabytes per second. Which, by the way, doesn't seem too bad running on Verizon Visible for only $40 a month, but we can get to that more later on. 5G can currently travel on a couple kinds of airwaves. One low band frequency and one high frequency. The plans are for low band frequency 5G to operate through 4G cell sites that companies already have in place. But the encoding will be more flexible and use a bigger channel size to get up to 50% better speed.
Is that too much to know? Is it too much?
This isn't too bad.
Maybe.
But since we want that multi
damn.
So check it out. So basically what it is there's different spectrums. People that's the reason why they shut down the television. Like, we can't watch television anymore on the antenna because they needed that spectrum for digital. And they share it up. And there's only so much of a circle. And they have to cut it up into pie sections. And that's where these different things come in. That's where the AM, FM, digital, your stuff that works on local bands, like your cordless phones and stuff like that. There's all these, you know, they have gigahertz. Those are different spectrum. And the 4G, the 5G is going to work on the spectrum the 4G is on, but apparently it's going to be more efficient. So it's going to be able to use a smaller section, like it's a bigger section.
Mm-hmm. But are we going to die?
There is a possibility because it has caused headaches. Birds have dropped out of the sky when these.
I don't know. I mean, the service at my house sucks so bad. I don't even think 6G would save it. Like.
So it's funny you say it because right now what they need to do is, short of beaming a signal to the satellites and coming back down, they use access points, all these like different spots, these fake trees, these antennas that look mm-hmm. like that are huge devices, right? Mm-hmm. With 5G, they're going to be able to put all that into a suitcase sized device, and they're going to be able to install them on top of houses, on top of buildings. And that's why they think the 5G signal is going to be able to be spread easier and better, more efficiently.
Mm-hmm. But means every company has to upgrade to that.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, well,
they are.
They want to be on the game.
They all are.
Yes, thank you. Fucking idiot.
Did you guys hear the story where the earbuds are like there's evidence that it might be linked to cancer, like just wearing Apple earbuds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's like I don't have Apple. I don't know. That has to go through your brain.
Yeah. Holy shit. I have no idea about that. I don't have an Apple.
Yeah, I really think, heard about that? Well, maybe. I mean, I'm not a scientist, so I don't fucking know. But I...
Phones have radiation.
My layman opinion is that this is, like, going to cause real health problems for people. and
birds.
And we are at the very tip of, like, the decline of modern world. It's down here from here.
That is true. And that's the reason. That's the reason we're already going to get there.
Or this is the point of like where it turns into the robots and then they take over.
Skynet. Told you.
The data is going to be
sex robots. That's all that Sally wants to know about. Sex robots. And when do I order mine?
Things that look like a certain celebrity.
Nice.
Or if I could customize it, that'd be great.
Have you seen those sex robots for dudes? The ones that look all like they look ghetto. They have like white girls with big booties.
No.
Yeah.
What? Girls with big booties. Yeah. Where?
It was on a hip hop website, and they're like, "Damn, these bitches are thick." And it was a white girl dressed up like a hip hop chick, and it was like a sex doll.
Mm-hmm. So they just made her white. It's a doll, but they made her white.
No, it was a white girl with a... I don't know.
Well, I mean, come on, dude.
I don't know. I don't have a copy of
that. It was a black robot, but they made her white.
Yeah, because, I mean, come on. See? She got it.
Yes.
Jesus Christ.
That's racist.
Jesus Christ!
Right, you're welcome.
Oh, check out this. You guys ever done Special K?
Special K?
You have done Special K?
Yes, sir.
Have you done Special K?
Been in the K-hole.
Yeah. Whoa. Oh, you got in the K-hole? Oh, that's dangerous, man. That's dangerous. I did Special K at a rave back in the days at a club. It's like, is it cat track?
It's ketamine. It is, yeah.
Horse or cat track?
Cat.
Cat tranquilizer. And it makes you feel like you're on ecstasy. Well, recently...
Why wouldn't you just do ecstasy?
Yeah,
that's fun.
I've done that.
It's whatever's around you.
It will. Yeah, it's because the cat tranquilizer is sometimes easier to get a hold of because it's kind of legal, more or less.
Okay. But for cats.
But the point is that they've studied it extensively, and I've heard that Special K was better for your depression. If you take it, if you have depression, don't take the ecstasy. Take the Special K, and now it's been proven by the FDA that Special K.
Oh, that's totally trustworthy. For sure. All the FDA says it's
right.
Cool.
Okay. Right. Cannabis isn't FDA approved, but cigarettes are, and alcohol is.
Wow.
And now
see?
Special K is.
There you go.
That's a good point. I can't say much after that.
I was doing nitrous with the K, and so it was a very simple.
Yeah, that's why. Is that how you got the K hole?
Yeah.
That's the problem. If you take too much of it, it will get you in a K hole and you'll get stuck. And I don't know what that's like, but
this
it's traumatizing.
You have to take in a controlled setting. You only can do it in the doctor's office.
Yes, exactly. That's good. That's the point that I was gonna make. Is this is not something you prescribe, you take home, and you do for fun.
So
like
they give it to you then and there.
Exactly.
This is probably gonna be our new opioid, though. Like,
oh shit.
Well, that's the thing is that's why they don't want to prescribe it and let you take it home because they don't want to find a way to abuse it.
Just yet.
So you have to take it in the doctor's office and you have to wait a few hours before they allow you to leave, and it's been known to treat.
So you got
to
spend a whole day in the doctor's office. You already did waiting in the waiting room, and you got to do extra after you take this thing.
She's taking in consideration the wait room time.
But you could be.
Yeah. I mean, come on. You get an appointment, and you still don't go on time,
and that's why I'm depressed.
But you see,
but you can get other things done too while you're while.
Like what? What happens if the Wi-Fi don't work in there?
Yeah,
I mean, and this 5G ain't kicking in yet. So what? I'm gonna be lagging it on my shows.
She did kill herself.
The magazines are old. Like there's no up to date magazines.
So just make sure you take something with you then.
What, snacks?
Snacks. Yeah.
There's that women's health issue from like 2000 something.
There you go. See,
women's health. Take my Kindle. Read a book.
Read a book. Yeah.
When I'm already waiting in the waiting room, and then I still got to wait for the doctor to get in there because they still don't get there on time.
Why
still
is
take
that, man?
What, I don't know. That's what I'm saying. You wait in the waiting room. You get in the waiting
room. There's a little waiting room. Right
there's a little waiting room that you're waiting. Like, and the doctor don't get in there. The nurses do, but the doctor don't. And then when the doctor does, you're only in there for 5 minutes. And then mm-hmm. they take. It's like, why do I do all this waiting? You're not going
to
help.
Why are they like the cable guy where you have to wait like this? Like your appointment.
Until the end of the day.
Your appointment is like 2 to 4.
Yeah. Like what the. And then I still have to wait after I take the drug. Thanks.
God damn it. Yeah. Moving on.
Thanks.
Damn, I haven't gave you guys one story. Oh, I guess the soccer story if I didn't ruin
the
it.
The blind one was
yeah,
good.
Yeah, we liked that.
But I ruined that
until
one.
Until you started talking.
Here's a video game. Here's a chick video gamer, and she's having problems because she's getting harassment online.
She's getting bullied for being a gamer?
Yeah.
For being a girl?
Idiot. Piece of
shit.
Woman.
I wanted to bring this because...
You know what? Men are so classy.
I'm going to rape you.
What? Yeah,
fuck.
That's what I wanted to bring it to you guys because this is serious, dude. This is stuff that I wouldn't say to chicks online or...
For being a girl? This is Trump's fault.
Yeah.
Yes,
it is.
Yes. Grab him by the pussy. That's just terrible.
This is awful. Men are awful.
So men can do it, but if a woman does it, she's going to get killed and raped?
Yeah.
No, to be fair, the guy probably would say the same harassing thing to men, but
in a different way.
But it's the fact that
it's a woman. I mean,
but yeah, it's a woman. You always had there was always a barrier. Like you say bad things, but you don't go that far.
Yeah.
I'd be like,
you suck, fuck you, you fucking bitch, but I wouldn't be like, I'm gonna rape you.
And I'm gonna kill you. I mean, just because she's better at it than you or she makes a mistake.
This is what's happening to me. Like, this isn't a joke. It's a serious thing.
Hey, girl, yo, stink. Come sound Pop-Pop's lab.
Please pee in a cup and send it to me online.
What the fuck?
I know that guy is serious, though.
Oh, really?
I'm sure that guy is serious.
Jesus Christ.
That guy would be jumping up and down if a pee cup came in his way.
It's really frustrating, honestly. Oh, me and other female gamers, all we want to do is play the game.
Yeah.
And having to listen to all of these rude comments is super frustrating.
Women are going to have
Let me tell you, back in my day, if we would have known a chick playing video games, we would have been totally okay with that because we would have been like, this chick's playing video games. That's just awesome.
I can be any boy at Mario Kart. Yeah, that's just where that is.
I probably wouldn't be mad at you, but the same level of mad at you that my friend, I would like, if it was a guy or girl, like.
The negative comments from men.
Just be like, oh, I'll rape you. Like, just don't be the victim. Just, like,
say what they're saying back at them.
I belong. Because
then they'll be like, what the fuck? She actually could talk back.
That is true.
Expect that.
They won't expect it.
That's why we need more jobs. We need more guys working.
Yeah.
They spend too much time on those video games.
Trump, you need to get on those jobs.
Stop grabbing them by the pussy, apparently.
Yes.
Want to lick my clit for nothing in return?
Yes.
Yes.
Want to smoke me out?
Yeah.
We need a helper. Let's send her comebacks.
What if she gets alerted? It's like harassment behavior. You said something harassing.
I know. She gets banned.
That dude's mom heard you and was like, no, you can't talk to my son like that.
He would have a mom like that.
Yeah. Right. Disgusting. Let me tell you, back in the days when I played online, it was a lot of the Canadian kids, and they were like, I would talk shit and they would get very sad, and the worst they would say to me is like, at least I don't have to lock my door, or at least I don't have to have bars on my window like a prisoner.
Oh shit.
I was like, wait, are you serious?
People have reached out and said that it helps them. They've said that you know, they experience the same thing. They've either gone out of their way to stop it, or there's been females saying, you know, this has helped me, I've been using my mic more. So I would definitely say, if any female gamers out there who are nervous about using their mics, just know that you have the ability to mute. You don't have to listen to people like I do, but definitely use your mic and try to.
So they're fighting back by muting those characters and then talking shit back.
I'd rather just talk shit back. I will talk shit back and say, why don't you shove that shit up your ass and see how you like it? Oh,
that's what they're doing. We're not talking shit, but they're fighting back by saying leave her alone and ganging up on the guy, and they're muting the dudes so they can't hear.
Well, yeah, that's good, but that's, it only takes one guy to do that. If no guys say it, then they all partake in it. So it has to take that one person to do it. But if you do it yourself and say, you know what, why don't you shove that shit up your ass, or look, you know what, why don't you go get raped in jail because, you know, whatever.
God damn.
Yeah, I would be going all out, because you know what, I want to play the game, and just because I can play it better than you doesn't mean you can be talking shit to me. So why don't you get your shit together and learn how to play the game right then.
I have so damn many gay friends. You're getting raped.
Yeah, see. Thank you.
Alright, moving on. I know Boozy like this.
For the longest time, the communities have suffered from the lack of water, but the women have been the ones who have been bearing the brunt of bringing water to their households and who have suffered the most.
They claim collecting moisture out of the air.
Technology for fog collection in this region.
It sounded like this. She said technology for fog collection.
It is in high elevation, and the wind pushes fog from the coastal region inside the land, inland, and the nets are put in such a way, oriented in such a way, when the fog travels through them, the small particles of fog that are filled with water are caught into the mesh, and they slide down into a gutter.
Alright. What part of the world is this? Oh yeah?
I forgot. It's at the beginning. Morocco. Oh, okay. Yeah. I was like, sorry.
In one single day, the women would waste and put about 3.5 hours a day for the chore of water. And there's never enough water.
For not having water, she has some clean ass teeth. God damn, that's my teeth.
For drinking and for cleaning. And so the amount of water that the women can bring is just finite.
Should we try collecting water like this, boo?
Yes, absolutely. Everyone should.
Yeah, you gotta wear a mask like that, though.
I'm down. I don't care.
Babies.
The women have gained back half a day, and they're putting this time into economic viable opportunities for themselves and for their households and communities.
Good for them.
Right on.
The freed up time from fetching water has been put more into the exploitation and the gathering of the argan fruits that make argan oil, which is today a commodity in the world you find everywhere.
Awesome.
That's dope.
Everybody should know a way to collect water. Everybody should have their own personal at-home water catching and filtration.
California
system.
Just recently legalized us to be able to collect rainwater.
Wow. For a cannabis grower, it's huge.
Is it?
Yes.
I think the reason why they had it illegal is because they wanted to control the water.
Exactly. Which is bullshit because it's a natural resource.
It didn't make no sense to me how you could tell me not to. I can't collect the rainwater. They try to say it was a health issue, but what do you mean health issue?
If it's coming from And
you can filter it too.
Yeah, exactly.
And if you live near an ocean, you can actually reverse osmosis, let it evaporate and drip into a cup, and then you have fresh water. In places like where you don't have that, that's an excellent idea. But if you have an ocean, that's a thought too.
Goddamn, dude.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. What about desalization? You guys down with that? Where they take the ocean water and they, but it takes so much energy, huh? I wish they could find a way to do that quicker, because we're going to need that in the next 20 years. We're
or we can have devices this, like this thing where that's we can going capture on. Natural
you know what
water.
Sucks is that they allowed Nestle and companies like that to pump our groundwater so quickly and so cheaply. It's fucking infuriating.
Yes, I don't understand how people haven't known about this for the last like 20 years.
Well, I've known about it for the last 10 years, but what the fuck am I going to do?
Yeah, what are you going to do?
I'm going to...
What are you going to do about it?
Oh, damn. She did the head nod todo.
I'm going to pretend I'm blind and go to a soccer game.
Oh, my God.
She's going to take out your eye sockets for that dream. Shit. She's literally going to make you go blind.
I'm going to play a couple of Marshall videos before we go.
Well, then he can go to soccer game.
So check this out. This is another technology helping people with disabilities.
For a live-action U.S. film.
So many of us spend hours a day binge-watching content on Netflix, on Hulu, on every platform you can think of, and sometimes we forget that it's not that easy for a lot of people, and ActiveU is all about making sure that inclusivity is a priority, and no one's left out of the entertainment and cultural experience that is movies and TV today.
Alex Corin is the founder of ActiveU, a mobile app that provides tools for people with disabilities.
Blind person going to their friend's house to watch a movie. When they go to do that, they have to either request to their friend, hey, can we turn on audio description on the speakers? Now everyone has to listen to that. Or they can pull out our app, put in headphones, and have that experience personalized to them while everyone else watches the way they normally would.
ActiveU offers different options for featured movies, like closed captioning, language translations, audio descriptions, and amplified audio.
Wow.
Users open the app, select a movie, pick a service, and the app will automatically sync to your exact spot in the movie by listening to the film's audio.
So,
and they'll start gathering your data immediately.
ActiveU recently partnered with entertainment company Lionsgate and model and disability activist Niall DeMarco to provide ASL interpretations for the 2017 film Wonder. The film tells the story of a boy with mandibulofacial dysostosis who struggles to fit in at his new elementary school.
ActiveU and Lionsgate chose to collaborate on this movie specifically because a lot of the stories we hear from our users are ones of trying to find a place of inclusion, trying to find a place of acceptance into being a part of a community and culture. And there was just an amazing alignment between Wonder's story and what our users go through every day in their everyday lives. So with so many barriers between a blind or deaf child and their classmates already, why should there be an extra barrier of not being able to even talk about the latest Star Wars or Harry Potter or Wonder?
Alex says users' positive responses inspire him to continue advocating for accessibility.
I'm 14 years old and I'm totally blind. We just saw Solo, a Star Wars story, at our local theater. I just finished watching Coco with descriptive audio. All I need is a phone and a pair of headphones. So I don't have to worry if a theater.
This guy's getting paid for this shit, right?
Descriptive audio headsets.
Better shit.
Approximately 8 million Americans have a vision impairment.
That kid's getting paid for that ad.
What if he impairment. Is?
The number of people
blind people good
can't
cause.
Get paid for their ads.
Blind child
just because they can't see the money doesn't mean they're not getting paid.
Yeah, for real.
Damn. Shit.
Say
it over here. You want to watch a soccer game blind.
Say, oh my God. 100, 200, 300.
Aw, you're a dick.
ActiveU features
concur.
An additional movie that users can watch.
I concur.
Terrible.
Alex hopes his app can continue his awareness about entertainment accessibility.
It's always been about experience first.
That's really cool.
I think
cool.
That a lot of people
I like
love
that. I like that.
What I thought this technology was, it would read your whatever you're watching and sync up with it. I didn't know it was a limited library. I misread the story then. But that's still pretty cool that they're able to offer this to people that it's not like it, because you go to the theater and they have those services available to you, but it's cool that you could go to people's houses or go anywhere and have that
just
available.
Watch it. Yeah. It's probably better than whatever the theater offers.
Theater has efficient ADD program.
How would you know?
Because you, when you ask them, they give you the earphones too.
Do they?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I've never seen that. They have all the options that they do? What if you're also hard of hearing? Like,
they give you the headphones.
No, what happens if you like really can't hear that well though? Even if they give you the headphones.
I don't know what to tell you.
That's why. Yeah, do they do the subtitles? Know. Do they give you that option? Like, I don't know. To they watch give the you movie subtitles. With subtitles.
That's
or...
like a whole array.
So
of
you're gonna be in a theater with
your...
the with your phone on and watch you read.
But
subtitles?
I mean, look, they're doing it on the little thing to watch the movie. They have it telling you.
That's gonna be annoying if I see somebody next to me with their.
But
phone
But that's what
on.
I'm saying. Like, they can't.
I'm gonna punch
see
them
it.
In the face.
Oh they can't God, see
you're so
it.
Annoying.
I'm gonna put you have your phone on at the theater.
People have their phone on, period, at the theater, and it's then like they're not even
annoying.
Blind.
And
yeah, it is
annoying,
but I mean, if this person actually has a handicap, they could put him in a certain section of the theater for them in the back so they can have access to that.
You're not even willing to explore any other options.
Damn.
All you're thinking about is like, oh, how is it
yourself.
Gonna bother me?
Selfish.
Why, if they're blind, then why do they need to be in the theater? They could just put them in the corner. And
you see,
know,
he can't even have
on.
Them in the theater. That's why they're doing it at home, because they don't even want to be in the theater. How sad.
I don't want to talk about this anymore. You're really annoying me.
This is good, and you're making it bad.
I'm saying.
You don't need to say anything.
No.
Like,
if they're blind,
quiet.
Why do they have to be
next
in the theater?
Story. Next story.
If they're blind, what happened
to
the theater?
No, stop.
All right, this is
Kitty.
This is for Boo.
Wow. Oh yeah. Okay. Wow.
I would never let watch? Tiggy go to that party.
It's quite a mosh pit.
Exactly.
Animals.
A lot of
But only for a short while, once the boats and ballots started rolling in from... Excuse me.
She licked him?
Yeah. Yeah. Wow, you're super pretty. You want to go on a date sometime?
We're on
what?
Live right now on KCLA, awesome. Actually.
As I said, the ambulance just left a fire truck. And there's a firefighter there right now. But everyone is outside. We're live now tonight.
Make his first appearance.
What the?
But in this case, LaBeouf obviously.
No, it does. Oh shit!
LaBeouf
she's
obviously
aggressive.
Kept on moving during the course of this scenario.
Coming up, I'm right here in Times Square, and I know he's here somewhere, and I cannot wait for the moment I can say I met.
Oh my god!
I think he was against you.
He was not ready for that.
Hell
no. Major disturbances. Everything has gone pretty smoothly. They say they've only had a couple arrests related to people who were drinking a little bit too much. Live in West Hollywood.
And hot.
Whoa!
I'm sorry.
What the fuck?
13th. You are Marcia.
I am. I almost jumped you there. Sorry
about
that.
That's okay. You can jump me anytime.
Oh!
Not that way.
Oh.
You know what I
mean. He was like, yo, I've been wanting to tell you this my whole life.
Your morning.
I'd be happy, man. Rangers to me are a sinking ship.
And we'll check back in with Tom in just a little bit. Definitely.
Part of Kristen Thorne is in Smithtown in Suffolk County tonight. She continues.
We have not gotten into the worst part of this storm yet. That is to come a little bit later on tonight. So
he need him in
That dude knows karate.
That could
karate.
Be
like,
the Justin Bieber of seasons. It was kind of cute and exciting when it first started out, and now it's a bit obnoxious and should probably just stay in Canada.
I said, what are you doing running? You're saying it was really good out?
It's the perfect texture for running. Very low impact when it's dry snow, so your feet don't get wet.
We've seen a lot of people out here, like you said, running, sledding, just enjoying it. That can happen.
Let's bring in Weather Channel meteorologist Mike Seidel. He's in Sugar Mountain, North Carolina. Hi, Mike.
Is he on his phone?
Why?
Well, Mike got quite ready for us, but let's turn to some other news we're following on this Saturday night.
I do.
Why
would he? The Super Bowl commercial. Did you get a lot of reaction to that Super Bowl commercial?
What Super Bowl commercial?
That wasn't him.
Oh,
You know what? My mistake.
You're as crazy as the people on Twitter.
Right.
I'm not Lawrence Fishburne.
That's my fault. I know. That was my mistake. You know what?
We don't all look alike.
Tell him.
Is down. We're expecting this to, trend on Twitter any moment. Here's the screen grab we have from our newsroom where people are unfortunately having trouble getting on. I got on, but nothing's uploading. Nothing is updating. It just allowed me to send a friend request. That's all. And in all seriousness, on Twitter, yeah, I just went and checked. Yeah, right now, hashtag Facebook down, trending. Facebook says they're working on getting it fixed soon. How about that?
The panel said it welcomed.
How was that interesting?
But said some of the financial costs could have been avoided. Caroline, thank you.
He says what you're doing is you're doing down the departmental spending because you need to find deeper
that
cuts
umbrella's not
in spending
holding
in government departments. So in real terms, that means spending on things like schools and hospitals. I might give up on that.
correspondent Nicholas Witchell has the details at Balmoral for us now. Nicholas, what does it say?
What the fuck? Did he fall?
He didn't remember.
He fell.
Did he fall? No, I don't think so. I think he just got a
changing complexion of this cabinet compared to
that guy's gonna have a heart attack.
The last one, the one yesterday, and what we can see is that
Is he choking?
Do you want to take a pause?
You know, because they've been talking nonstop. You okay?
No, I swallowed a fly. That's all right. But I've.
Wow.
No, he did
I didn't
not.
Make anybody stay here until 7 a.m. or 11 or whenever it is everybody finally left. I didn't make this kid pass out on my floor.
Oh, shit.
People wanted to be here.
Louis Slungsu. I hope I pronounced the last name correctly.
Yes, ma'am. It's Slungsu.
Oh, thank you very much. What can you tell us about this? Is it something you've ever seen before like this?
We had a pressure break around sunset, and the cherry bomb must have popped through the top of the pipe and just blew the bottom right out of it. It was either a cherry bomb or someone took a really large dump, you know?
Are you sure about that? That's
a fake call.
Oh,
it's a fake call.
Sorry about that. We hope to get him back.
It was great. I've never been on live television before. Apparently, sometimes I don't watch the news because I'm a kid. Apparently, every time, Grandpa just gives me a remote after we watch the Powerball. Well, it was great.
Why?
Because apparently you're spinning around. Apparently, every time you get dizzy,
that's
all you do is get dizzy. Yeah, and I've never ever been on live television. I never ever be on live television.
Are you excited?
Yeah, and apparently I already went down the super slide.
Apparently.
I went down the one I was scared half to death. I just freaked
out. Oh my god, that was so cool.
He was cute. All
right, that's all those bloopers for the news. Hopefully that made you guys forget everything, all the dumb shit that I said.
Well, why did you bring it up?
Because it's what I do. I say the wrong thing. Lady Boo, I'm sorry.
Skip me.
Are you exhausted? Are you still going to want to go to the brewery after this?
Yeah, I want to go to the brewery.
Just without me.
We might survey people to think to ask what they think about you going to a soccer game being a blind person.
I honestly think people would be more open to it than you expect.
To go that you're not blind, but to go just to experience what blind people deal with.
Yes.
No,
to watch a game.
I think more people would be a better. Don't you guys think that would be?
Because that means they can't even watch anything. Like they were born, they could either been born that way, or it could have just happened to them, and then they missed out on everything, and that's the only way that they can find a way to enjoy it. That's just messed up.
Yeah. When you put it like that.
Yeah, that's how it was at the beginning. Hello.
You wouldn't even last 5 minutes, I bet you. You'd be
how
like,
much you want to bet you lose your car keys and you're already blind if you lose your car keys because you can't find them, but they're right in front of you?
Yes.
Yeah, it's true. I wouldn't last 5 minutes in any soccer game.
No, you wouldn't last 5 minutes as a blind person in a soccer game. You wouldn't last 5 minutes as a blind person anywhere.
Not even if you lost your keys.
I can close my eyes for 5 minutes.
No, you can't.
And walk around?
Hey.
No, he without stepping on it.
He doesn't even have to walk around. I bet if you tell him sit there with your eyes closed 5 minutes, he couldn't do it.
He probably peek, huh?
Cheater. I have problems sleeping, so I know you're right.
Oh.
You'll be able to do it. You're just disrespectful.
Aww. Why you have to be like that?
What do you mean? I'm not ashamed. Hey, you're disrespectful.
But I am blind. Without my glasses, I'm pretty blind.
Oh, that's pretty. Yeah, let's just take off your glasses.
See, you guys are haters.
I ain't hating. Says the one that's partially blind. You're not fully blind, so you still have that vision. That's it's just a little blur. You're just a little blur. That's all.
This coming from the visually impaired, visually impaired.
No, I just changed my stance. Half blind people are
Martha,
dorks.
Back me up here. You have glasses too. That's messed up. That's messed up.
You're on your own.
No love for the sisters. That's messed up. So what do you guys think about this 420, this new law that recently, it was in 2016 or 17? 17, right? That it went into effect, the law?
Twas 2018, January 1st, 2018.
We voted on it in 2017.
We voted for it in November 2017.
17, okay. Fuck, because they were running for election forever. Anyways, the point is the law went into effect in 18. We had a whole year of it. And so far on the radio, I've heard how businesses are just mad because this tax is killing them. They say that these illegal shops are just taking them out left and right because... the taxes are killing them on the retail side and on the growing side.
You know, the law made it so that weed is not for poor people.
So you're against the law then?
No, I'm not. Honestly, like as a consumer,
yeah,
I feel very good about walking into a legit store that doesn't have girls with their titties hanging out and not playing hip hop. I have a very nice young man who I'm sure has a very bright future ahead of him helping me. And I don't mind paying more for that. Like just from like a very micro myself point of view.
And how much more have you think you paid?
Oh, a lot.
Yeah. A lot more, right?
Yeah. So what we pay, what do we pay for five at your shop?
For what? For the
Blue Dream?
For the Blue Dream? Like let's 25? Just say eighth is $20.
$20? That's what we pay?
Yeah.
No.
For an eighth? Yeah.
Oh, well, at the other shop, I'm paying 40.
Okay.
So for an eighth?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And the pins are like 42.
Yeah. Oh. And the pins are 25 at this shop or 20. Yeah.
Oh, okay. But I would much rather go to the other shop and pay more, except that the one that we go to is a lot closer.
And it's funny you mentioned the titty thing, because I never realized how many girls in LA had big titties till they opened these shops, because they all just seem to get the fucking job there. I don't get the fucking, well, I do get the point.
Well, it means to distract you, so when you put it on the scale, they don't say or whatever, and they charge you more, or they don't give you the amount that you paid for.
Oh, I'm always paying attention to scale.
Yeah, but that's for those that don't actually pay attention, because they're like, oh, yeah, and they're like telling them this, telling them that, getting distracted, looking at them or looking at other while they don't really pay attention. And then they wonder why they don't have enough left, or like, I paid this much, but they don't. Then they wonder why, so then that gives them a reason to go back to the shop.
When I first started buying, a lot of shops had the stuff pre-rayed, and that shit would piss me off. And
really?
It was later on that a lot of spots would weigh it out in front of you later.
Wow.
I've had my medical license for a while. I don't know, for a long time.
2007.
Wow. She knows. How long have you had your medical license for?
2003.
Wow. So you got it like...
The very first shops in LA, I went to those.
How were those like?
One was called the Yellow House in West Hollywood on La Brea. And it later, they were raided. I got some of the last weed out of it before they were raided. And then it later was burned down. And like,
oh my God.
Fuck, burned down.
Wow.
Yeah.
Why was it burned down?
That's a separate, no one knows. But like, that was like a fluke. But anyway, perhaps they were trying to get insurance money or something. But
yeah.
But,
I remember
I was feeling bad for them.
I remember going to a spot when I first got my medical license, and we pulled up to it, and I was like, knocked on the door, and they're like, nah, we don't accept people on Tuesdays, only on Mondays. And I was like, what the fuck? And that was like the first shop I went to. I was like, is this what it's going to be like? You're going to go sign up on certain days, and you can only buy on other days? It was weird.
For new patients, it's kind of a long thing to like... call your doctor, verify that your doctor is even a real doctor, and like,
yeah. Are any of them real doctors?
Yes, yes, and yes, you can check the medical board and it triple confirm that your cannabis
we never check
is a real
the
doctor.
Medical board.
We don't need to do that anymore, and, yeah. And things. But yes, what have we done? My friends at Cannabis Quencher will tell me that, like, so the Bureau of Cannabis will come in. If a batch of anything doesn't match the test results that they require, if there's anything not compliant about that batch, they will come and watch you destroy that batch to wow. make sure that you've destroyed it. So what we've done with legalization is now we've got a barcode tracking everything from seed yes. to sale. So for the farmers, this isn't really cute. This is they're making sure they get their cut on every single plant. And with Prop 215, that just wasn't a thing. That wasn't a thing.
So how valid do you think these tests are? Like, what is their value? Do they have the actual value of making the cannabis safer for the consumer?
So yes, and depending on the lab, and there are some shady labs, and your test results for the same thing can vary depending on the lab, mm-hmm. and that's an interesting point. But yes, for the consumer, I had a guy write to me like, oh, I don't know, there's mold. I saw this article about all the mold, and I was like, no, now you never have to worry about that again. Just walk into a legal cannabis shop, and everything's tested. It shows the test results right there on the packaging now, and so that is a beautiful thing.
So is that to the recent where they did that? They bought like different CBD oils from different places to see if it actually had the right chemicals, or like if there was stuff inside that did. So when they smoked it or whatever, it didn't like. Do a justice, so because they didn't have it, so like certain shops, like they had more of this instead of what it was supposed to be, all natural and kind of stuff like that. Is that because I like saw that?
That's a thing too, for yeah, right? sure. Okay. Like, and there's CBD that's hemp derived, or yeah, there's uh-huh. cannabis derived CBD, and there's yeah. full spectrum CBD, and uh-huh. there's like, most people say it doesn't taste great, and it's really right. just anti inflammatory, and THC is actually very medicinal, right. also.
Oh, okay, yeah, because I was like, what the hell? Like, you can't even go to a shop and get something because it's not the proper, and you take...
Like, that's true. And edibles, like, they took a bunch of edibles yeah, to test, yeah, and only some of them were what they said they were.
And the yeah. other ones didn't have it on there, but they had more of this and not they even close it was, of it. Yeah, like, it wasn't exactly. even none of it in there, so it was like, now, holy shit.
Is that intentional, or do you think that's... Or is that just the normal process of the cannabis products? It's going to different, and you can't get it to an exact science.
Like, Kiva was one of the ones that like was accurate, mm-hmm. and most of the other ones they're just doing it by
so
per batch
possible.
And they're just
batch.
Kind of
okay
guesstimating gotcha. Like oops they put two spoonfuls in
wow, interesting.
And why is Kiva doing it so exact? Is it because they're doing small batches and they're doing like exact science?
Yeah, well, so like they have like a real lab and there is an exact science on the exact dosage and per thing, and they're doing it right, and now most more companies are doing it right, so that is it has forced people to step up to the plate. And
well, also it's easier to do it right because they regulate how much there could be in each one, so they have to bring it down anyways.
Correct. No more than 100 milligrams now. And there used to be 1,000 milligrams.
1,000 milligrams.
That
yes.
became recreational. It's not medicinal at that point. That's right.
Yeah.
yeah. yeah. I don't. Edibles don't hit me. Shout out to Yoli Edibles, by the way. They do hit me all the time. But edibles usually don't hit me. But there was this one edible that I had a long time ago that wasn't enough to make me pull over when I was driving to go get something to eat. And I was like, God damn, I'm fucking tripping. Remember that brownie that I had? I told you about. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was pretty bad. I mean, I'm glad about the new law. I'm glad that it's legal and recreationally. I'm glad that I could have it and don't have to have a medical license, even though I did for so many years. And it was, you have to take the lid off first.
That's the second time I did that.
We enjoying ourselves over here too much with the wine. No, good. Or the bubbly.
Good. The bubbly on your lips.
Yep. It's delicious.
So what would have been the perfect law to have, though?
Well, let's talk about first so that I understand, like, yeah. what mm-hmm. is going wrong?
Yeah, what's going wrong?
Okay. Oh, cool. I mean, yeah, so right. So I was an advocate for the Jack Herrera initiative that he reported. He died would have given us more freedom than we currently have instead of less freedom. We were going to be allowed to do 99 plants instead of now just being over 21. You can grow 6 plants. No paperwork, no questions. If you have like 6 people in your house, you can have 6 plants per person. Mm-hmm. Hint, hint, you can without any... license or anything, but it's tough to get a license, a proper distribution license, a proper cultivation license.
But do you think it's going to be tough forever, or is it tough now because it's just getting started and there's so much to iron out?
That's probably true, that hopefully they will open it up more, but yeah, right now it is very strict and they're only doing the shops that have already been around for years doing it properly and paying their taxes properly. And there's like $100 million enforcement to get rid of the illegal shops.
Do you think that's good, because do you think the illegal shops are bringing down the quality?
Not necessarily. Like, just because they aren't paying taxes doesn't mean, you know, like, if you ever watch Murder Mountain on Netflix, it really explains the Humboldt mentality that twas the golden age, twas the Wild West, and a lot of money was being made without cutting in Big Brother and stuff, and the quality wasn't sacrificed at all. But
well, maybe not the quality, but what about the the illegal workings around it? Like, it's called Murder Mountain for a reason.
That's
right?
True.
Like, you're like going into like narco territory.
Okay. True.
So what is the cost of life compared to the cost of just business?
True. And hopefully, right, there's no cartels, and we're keeping out the and hopefully there will be less murders over marijuana. If we're doing it properly, and the cops can now actually enforce some of these things. True.
Okay.
No, but for sure. And back in the days, I know people who grew in the Humboldt County, and what he said was, if you're from around there and you have roots and you have like tradition, then you're good to go. But if you're trying to be a newcomer going up there, yeah, it's going to be rough going, really rough going. And the Emerald Triangle, which is that area up there, that's what they call it.
And it's this, I haven't seen the movie because it just kind of seems depressing, but it is on my radar. I was just like, haven't wanted to watch depressing stuff.
Just
it's like on my list or something.
Nice.
Oh, cool.
But, so are they cultivating in their own lands, or is this a story about the cultivation that's like in state parks and national parks that's completely illegal?
It is on their own land, and was before the age of legalization is this timeline of the story, and just a bunch of people are missing up there. I actually had a friend that went missing up there, and sure he's gone. Wow. He's gone. Yeah, that's all right. But he owed a lot of people money up there, and when we had to take law into our own hands, that's how that works, I guess. But it's a great show. It focuses on one particular murder case. Where actually someone owed him money and shot him dead instead of paying him.
Wow.
But yeah, they were growing on their own land. And in the show, the cops go after this one particular parcel, and they find out, they get there, and they find out they're at the wrong spot. There's places all next to each other, and they had all their paperwork to the T, in good standing with the state, and they had to leave, and they were so scared. What if the cops destroy our plants? Even though we have all our paperwork, they can just come in and just do whatever they want, set everything on fire.
Federally.
Okay.
Federally.
We're working on it.
Who is sending? Who is out to get them? I know the federal government, but up to what tip off or what motivation? Just to set the example.
Exactly. These were state troopers going after trying to set examples up there. But they set an example. Industrial hemp and CBD were just federally legalized on December 20th. We signed an agricultural bill signed by the president, Trump of all people.
Wow.
So CBD, which we had been shipping all over the country with no qualms, is now actually federally legal. But THC is still now...
No, but THC.
Well, so the government has patent number 6630507 on the medicinal properties of cannabis, including the THC variety, stating that it's anti-inflammatory.
The government does?
Yes.
You guys, you guys don't know, the government has the patent on on the medical properties
of THC.
Holy shit! I didn't.
Making
it
scheduling unfounded. The definition of a Schedule I drug is that it has no medicinal properties. And we think by 2020 we're going to get the whole plant federally legal.
Isn't it ironic?
Wow.
Think,
why do you think that? Why hasn't moved towards that? What is it that has made that turnaround where Trump would be signing this, you know, this law or whatever? And then why do you think that in the future we will have all of the plant?
Well, I think some tiny grassroots people like me who've been doing this activism for 15 years or more, really pushing this movement and educating. I've been flying all over the country teaching cultivation and educating people in Florida and Chicago and Seattle and Portland about, holy God, there's a reason this plant is on this planet. It's not a coincidence that we all have cannabinoid receptors in our brain and an endocannabinoid system in our bodies. It was put on this planet for a reason. So I think it will be federally legalized, because as each state legalizes it, we can't. Now our government's against our country.
Right.
Now we got more than half the country that is saying one thing, and our government's saying another thing. We're at a tipping point.
So you think this is coming from the people?
Yeah, absolutely.
From the people up.
I think so, but yeah. What do you think?
What do you think?
And it's a business thing, so if there's any business, you know, minded, I mean, FDA approved tobacco and alcohol, as long as they get their cut.
Gotcha. Mm. Yeah.
It's all so there's, dumb business.
There's more public acceptance and and requests for it, a need for it. So they're now thinking they're going to be able to make some money.
Yes,
off
especially
of it.
With large. And now that the corporations are coming in and Coca-Cola wants a cannabis flavor and everything, all of it, they're going to push. Big corporations are going to push it.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what that was. That was weird. But
it sounded like a doorbell.
Yeah, it did. So I'm tripping out. But so you said you flew out of the country to talk about this. What was the least receptive spot that gave you the most difficulty? Like, just wasn't getting it.
I was in Florida before it was in West Palm Beach, well before even medicinal cannabis there. But they grow some serious shit there. They call it crypto. It's not chronic. It's got that humidity there. It's like a rainforest environment for the most amazing sticky cannabis you ain't never. But it's still, and it is the highest opioid crisis there with the old people retiring, and they're just all hopped up on every pill that exists. Mm-hmm. And you don't need pills to sleep. You can just smoke a joint. You don't need pills for pain. You can just smoke a joint. Well, then, and I was teaching them that.
They got recently in a lot of trouble.
Now they can do that,
They recently got a lot of trouble because of the opioid easy access, because you could literally walk into any spot. It was like a liquor store. You could walk in there and ask for whatever medicine you want, practically without a medication, and then get what you wanted, and then go to the next spot and get more, and go to the next spot and get more. It didn't matter. Or you could use the same prescription and just keep showing it to them and then keep getting more of these pills, and that's why they got in a lot of trouble. That's why they're trying to get out of the opioid game, whatever.
My question is, like, since this is becoming more of a thing and everybody's getting more political and paying attention to everything that's going on because of the new president that we have, do you think, like, honestly, it's going to be taught in the schools? Because, I mean, these kids get access to it and their parents do it and their parents, like, advocate for it. So, of course, they're going to probably, like, give it to their children or the ones that have problems, like, health issues, and they use it and it helps them. But yet, like, they're like, no, whatever, because whatever, medical reasons. But do you think it's going to be taught as an actual education thing? Because it is going to be a business thing now. So is it going to be taught as an educational thing? Like, you know, yes, drugs is, because they tell us, oh, you know, the whole DARE thing and everything. But this is an actual plan. This is something that actually can help you. Mm-hmm. Do you think they're going to advocate it more to, like, teach it in schools and let kids be aware of it? Because, I mean, if they're going to have access to it when they're older, or, like, let's say their parents give it to them. And because I know some kids actually get medicine on campus. So, like, if the child has to have medication in school, they have to get it they have to get it properly through the doctor, and the doctor has to say yes, and it has to be on the campus because the student has to have it. Mm-hmm. Whether they have, like, ADHD or whatever, they have pills and inhaler, they have to have it on campus, because if they're not at home, they need to have it at school. So do you think it's going to be okay for them to use it in the class at school if the kid needs it?
I think the epileptic children that have found that it stops their seizures, like a CBD vape pen, I think they could.
That's what I'm saying, but it's in public schools, because I know private and
it's federally legal. So,
that's what I'm saying. Like, are there going to be boundaries? Is it going to be taught? Because, I mean, the people that have to give it to them, like the nurse or whoever has to give it to them, they have to be aware of it, because if they don't use it themselves or they're not aware of this, whatever it is, then they have to know about it. And then whoever gives it to them, or they tell them, oh, this student has to have this, so don't worry, it's all legal and know, you get me.
It was recently brought up in a situation, because the kids, like you said, like epileptic seizure people are getting prescribed, and like you said, the nurses and ministry it's on a school by school basis. So mm-hmm. some schools are taking the initiative of addressing it either classroom by classroom or mm-hmm. school by school, mm-hmm. but it's not federally, like it's not a program across every school or every district.
Yeah, for real. One school, like let's say in California, might be cool with it, but you know, middle America, you're going to get arrested and take your baby taken away from you.
Or even for example, LAUSD,
because in California itself, yeah, we have LAUSD, but there's also like Montebello School District. It's even within, because they all have different rules and regulations.
But I'm saying even within the district of one district, LAUSD, it's school by school.
Or
even classroom by classroom. They might not tell every classroom about it, but they might tell this classroom, like, hey, this student's leaving for this reason. Just like if they were gaining chemo or something, you know?
But that's what I'm saying. Like if a student in that class has it, but the thing is, it has to be known throughout the whole administration to let them know, like, hey, this student has to use this medical stuff.
Well, it's hard to. No, wait, because there's medical.
You can't tell the whole school this.
Not the whole school. I'm saying administration has to know.
There's that kid that's on that man. Let's go get him.
The administration in the school, the people that's allowed.
But there's laws against telling people's medical records.
Saying medical records, like, because since they're on campus.
I think it's still very restricted on who can know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Besides the nurse that has to give it to them. That's what I'm saying. Like, do some schools have to know? Do only the nurses have to know? The one that has to give it to the child.
Sally, you're asking like way down
for children. Yeah, that's a lot.
I'm just asking because I
have a college botany teacher friend that does touch on cannabis cultivation, and like it's just is another plant. Like it's just it grows.
Yeah, like college, I understand, but I'm saying like if actual kids need it because of whatever symptoms they have, they use it. That's what I'm saying.
But there's only been a couple of cases so far where that's came up, and in those cases, the nurse has, you know, obviously she knows about it because she has to administer it.
Yeah.
And the students, in one of the cases, I know that the teacher went ahead and addressed it with the classroom, but I'm assuming with the parents' permission because there's laws against any medical.
HIPAA.
That's what I'm saying. Like each district has their own set of rules, and I don't know how they go about it because each district is different.
I don't think you're gonna know unless you have a kid.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
If you're dealing with that with one of your kids.
I think that's a really difficult question.
But adults can come to my 710 college classes and learn it.
And what do you teach at those 710 college classes?
Cannabis cultivation, how to be compliant, how to start your own company, your own shop, your own farm compliantly as possible to state laws until it's federal.
Is it worth starting your own shop these days? Because I remember back in the days it was a big business, but now it just seems like a crapshoot.
True. Nowadays, like my friends at Cannabis Quencher are saying, they are losing massive amounts of money with the Bureau coming in and making them destroy all of their product, and it's been.
But okay, is there any appeal process? Like you said, different labs can have different results.
True. Mm-hmm.
So can you appeal for a different lab? And if a second lab determines that the results are not satisfactory,
you get three chances.
Oh, perfect. Oh. So if you fail three times, then you should get rid of your shit, in my opinion. Okay. I don't want it.
Right.
Nobody's going to want it.
Yeah. So I think it's getting like the folks that are running the shops are getting pretty defensive because it is a tough task. It is
it's very expensive
order.
Too.
Yes, but that's the future. That's what they're going to have to adapt to, or they're going to fall through. And that's just like any other business. You either, you know, get up to regulation, find your consumer, or you fail, and that's capitalism.
Yeah.
I go to a spot where I get my grams of wax for $5. Now, I smoke a lot, and I can't afford to spend the amount that I do on better spots. Now, if it came down to it, I would figure out a way to do it or cut down. And that's the way I feel about America too. Like everybody's like, oh, it's China by China, and I buy a lot of China shit. But if it came down to it, and everybody had to buy American, I would buy American for more expensive, you know, because I'm down with supporting that and being better. Okay. But some people are just not gonna be down with that, and they're gonna find ways around it. So with that said, do you think the government's ever gonna reduce the taxes like they're fighting for right now? Because
Yes, we're hoping to actually overturn Prop 64 and get
overturn it completely.
That would be neat. Yeah.
But then
and
that would make
overturn. It, well, we would
overturn
replace
and replace at the same time, or would the overturn and then the replacement come?
Yeah, because they got rid of Prop 215, the medical. They got rid of it.
Yeah.
Now into 2019, you have to be compliant to Prop 64, or you're not compliant anymore.
What's the difference?
So I think we would do the similar. Okay, well, I mean, it's medicinal cannabis, so you didn't have to have a barcode on everything. You don't have to.
But
charge
why
tax.
Would medicinal not be held to the same standard as a recreation or even higher?
It's the only medicine that's taxed on the planet. It's a medicine. Whoa. We don't normally tax medicine.
Right.
But that if you're partying with it, suddenly there's a sin tax.
So whoa. So basically they. Do they not recognize it as a medicinal?
Exactly.
Drug
that's
now?
What we've effing wow. done with Prop 64, which nobody read. That's all right. And we signed it and thought, boy, this is going to be great. And that's it.
But
now,
if you guys revert.
So could they. I'm sorry.
We can.
So instead of reverting, though, could we add another prop that serves cannabis as a medicinal? So, kind of like Colorado, they have two lines, one for medicinal and one for recreation. I imagine, I don't know, but I imagine they're both held to the same quality standards.
Exactly. My friend there will tell you it's the same building, just different doors with different locks.
Right.
And
one
gets charged differently than the other.
Okay. I'd totally be down for that. So could we do that? Could we reintroduce a medicinal?
We've really voted for this thing where it's just like Washington State now, where they've gotten rid of medical because they weren't making as much tax money off on it.
Wow.
God forbid.
I'm not familiar, but was it because folks were still resorting to the underground illegal stores that were much cheaper? Or
the black market is still thriving.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, so the black market still exists. It was
totally.
Just
yes.
the legal market.
And
so,
it's like that we've paved this way.
They
like,
failed to kind of wrangle it in under control. Now, do they have a separate medical and separate recreation policies?
Huh.
Or it was that
currently,
all like we are?
Currently, we've regulated medical out of existence.
Washington.
We could, yes, correct.
They only had one. They
had
so
both
we don't have medical.
They,
we don't have medical anymore.
Still,
we have no medical anymore. We don't have no doctors or nothing.
It's not a thing anymore.
Really? I didn't know that.
Wow.
I didn't know that either. Yeah.
Wow. I didn't know that.
Fuck.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
So if you reverse Prop 64, then we won't have recreational either.
Well, okay. So the California Cannabis Hemp Initiative that we're going to try to get on the ballot again in 2020 would have medicinal at the same time as recreational if there's a way to undo this Prop 64 thing.
But how is your prop going to even initiate that?
You'd have to read the whole thing, but yes. So it's going to allow like 99 plants instead of just 6, and you wouldn't need to have a barker. You would have the option of having a medicinal garden, or you can have a recreational garden. And we've got Monsanto and Bayer and the big corporations coming in.
Trying to fight it.
Very excited to take over and get all the mom and pops out of business, and that's all right.
Yeah. Who would trust Monsanto
yes,
now?
Yes, yes,
yes. Question,
lady.
Question.
Yes. Okay, I'm like...
On the mic.
I'm the kind of slow one here, you know, everybody's like, oh, like ask questions, and I'm just like, dude. But what is the difference between medicinal and recreational?
Okay, I mean, it's the same plant. It's the same plant, okay. And it's after the 5 hits, then it becomes recreational, but I'm kidding. Here. Depending on how high you are.
It's really what you use it for.
Yeah,
and it has just literally the tax.
It's literally
it's
the same
only,
thing.
It's the same product.
Yeah.
It's just
medical
now taxed more.
Tax
if, you,
and
if, you, if you do it for fun, they tax you more. If you do it because you're sick, they tax you less.
Yeah,
you shouldn't be taxed at all.
Yeah,
you shouldn't be. But
it really is a medicine.
And also, the same question would be for CBD and THC. So, does the CBD fall into the medicinal part, and the THC for the recreational?
I love that. I love that. And I love that. So I guess yes. The people have decided that for some reason. But the truth is, THC is very medicinal. And in fact, I had a cancer patient friend. It's the ratio of CBD with a little bit of THC is actually way better than just pure CBD. And it is very, they're both very medicinal, and the government's patent on it, 6630507, look at him, it's very exciting. They know that, yes, THC, in fact, has the medicinal properties and is also an anti-inflammatory and tells cancer cells to die and encourages new cells to live. And yes, they're both medicinal. Oh. At the end of the day, the whole plant is medicinal, but we've now declared
it's just how they do it, how variations.
So they can tax it.
Oh, fuck.
That's terrible.
So fuck cancer.
What would an ideal policy look like to you?
Yes, just we need to be able to have freedom. I would like to, I like that at least I can grow my 6 plants without any questions or barcodes and that they're for personal use.
So if you want more than 6 plants, you need a barcode?
Yeah, or a distribution license.
That's why she
says
she wants to do where they can
license.
Do 99 instead of the 6, right?
Yeah, because it used to be, even before that, it was like 15 or 14 plants. You can have mature.
There was 12 mature 12. And 6 little ones, but we would teach our students that at the end of the day, the cops can come in and call a clone a pound if they want to. So the rule of thumb was 6 still.
Really?
To be triple safe.
Wow.
Okay.
A clone a pound.
they can do that. They can decide that.
Who decides that?
The cops can just come in and decide that they can call anything. Yeah.
Have you ever had the cops call on you?
I did have cops come to a place I was growing for a violent crime that had nothing to do with my grow.
Yeah.
But they smelled it.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, is this why there's
a fight?
Yeah.
So they blamed it on that. It's like, no.
Yeah. I think it was entirely separate. But I was like, you know, listen, I worked really hard for legalization. I was a petitioner. Like, I have 6 legal plants and I am over 21 and like, fucking try me. And like, I would win the court case. That's fine.
Exactly.
And then at the end of the day, this is for fun. You go all the way to court with this shit.
Yeah.
It turned purple in the bag. I know what marijuana looks like. How do you know it's not hemp? Well, it turned purple. No, because they don't know that it's not hemp. Hemp is federally legal. They don't know that it's not the CBD, right? They can't prove that. There's no court-approved lab.
Yeah.
So they can sit there on the stand all day, and you can just be like, no, it's hemp.
Yeah.
And there's no way to prove you wrong.
Wow. Goddamn. That's
good to know.
That's good. Mm-hmm.
So let's say we were allowed to grow our 100 plants and Dre
99.
And I
99.
Over 99 becomes a federal issue.
That's right. So we each grow 95 plants. What are we going to do with them? Is our intent to sell it, consume it all? Like, what are me as an individual, what am I going to do with 95 pounds?
True. Plants. I mean, how it was working with Prop 215 is we're now part of a collective, and you could go into a shop and be like, I'm a member of your collective, and different collectives would purchase things that you've grown.
So I could sell it under the medicinal umbrella.
Right, you could start your own collective and have patients, and that's how it was working, is I could grow 6 plants per patient in my collective.
Gotcha.
Wow, gotcha. Okay.
So that's a lot of plants if you have like 500
patients.
That is patients.
A lot of plants. That is a lot of plants.
But
it's under
now
legal
you
thing,
can't do
so.
That anymore. You have to. Everything's licensed. Everything has to be barcode. Everything's tracked.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Goddamn.
They don't want you to
But it's cool that we can smoke weed and we can walk around.
Yes.
It's nice.
I mean, don't feel like a criminal.
I don't feel like a criminal anymore.
You don't have to hide it anymore.
And I don't think my job drug tests as much as it used to.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, since people are doing it more, are they going to restrict that? Well, not restrict it, but I mean, like, not really care so much because they know everybody does it, whether it's medical or not, because it's already legal.
Job
like,
by job.
Right.
If you're working federally, like, you're definitely going to get
it. It's always
doctors, pilots, though. It's kind of nice to know your doctor is
not
like fully. Yeah.
Okay.
I wouldn't mind. My doctor was like, "Yo, man,
I'm like, give you some
of
this.
Doctor to be high.
You need this more than I do."
No, it's like, I mean, now when she said like the doctors or anything, it's like, I know.
Doctor getting high?
No, my career is phlebotomy tech.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So
I mean, if I were to want to probably get high before,
yeah,
like, would that affect like
Probably.
Maybe.
Maybe. Yeah. I don't know. I really think it depends person by person.
Like yeah. the testing. I mean, like.
Because you know how something is with a random drug test or something yeah. like that.
Mm-hmm. Like the, what, oh, yeah. Would the testing be like? Oh, well, unless you can't be high.
Yeah, or, unless, yeah. or do they put like certain regulations as to how high you can be? Because like, depending how much you have.
Well, that's
like you can have a certain alcohol content.
Exactly.
Yeah. No,
to be considered as a DUI. So it's like, I mean, same thing with the weed.
There is a limit to how high you could be. And they have created devices that are like
they'll swab your cheek.
No, no, no. This one's the blow. They created a blow device that's able to measure how much THC in your system.
But see, that's what I'm saying. Like, if they do that for jobs, like they can't say swab it. If you do this, if it's a medical thing that you have to smoke,
they decided to make active THC a certain amount, and they could measure it. And if you're over it, they could put a DUI on you.
So then that's why we do the whole labs and stuff to make sure we have.
But THC is in your system for a month, so it's not fair.
The word is active THC. I don't know what the fuck that means. But it sounds like bullshit.
Active supposedly THC, but if it stays in your okay.
And in Canada, where they've federally legalized it, so the cops can smoke weed off duty.
Yeah.
So they can go home, they can get as high as they want, just not while on duty.
On duty.
Okay, see, that's what I'm saying.
And that's why they don't roughhouse people.
Like, smoke it home.
This is where the other one comes in. My other question, like how she said, like, not getting as high or for a medical reason, right?
Yeah.
As of now, I'm obviously taking medication. I'm taking pills because that's the only thing that my parents approve. At home.
Okay.
And because that's the only thing that my doctor has told me that I haven't gotten another option. I suffer from migraines.
Yeah.
I do get, I don't easily fall asleep, and I have lupus.
Okay.
So it's like three different medications and whatnot. But say if for the migraines, if I am having a migraine at work, say at my break, I want to smoke.
Right.
To remove that migraine, would they be reprimanding me for that because I have a migraine? Like, do you want me to be poking somebody with a migraine, or would you rather?
That's a good point.
See, that's what I'm saying. Like that. Like, if you have to have it because of whatever.
Now, what I'm gonna say is if it's medically prescribed to you, then that's something to argue with your medical employer with. But recreationally, even though it's legal, they could still not allow it on their property
or around their.
Just like they restrict cigarettes at my location.
It all depends the side effects. So, what are the side effects of your headache pills? Would they even be okay with you taking a headache pill that, you know, depending on the side effects? Because a lot of medication, you're not supposed to drive, you're not supposed to work while you're
definitely
on it.
The migraine pill, and I hardly take it. I would rather just deal with the migraine the whole day, or sometimes even 3 days nonstop, headache. Because it literally just makes, I compare it to when they give you a morphine dosage at the hospital.
Damn.
Like, it literally just brings you down. You take that pill, and if you're trying to do something, you won't even know how the heck you did it or if you even did it.
Yeah.
I literally take that pill, go to my bed, sleep it off.
Would that be acceptable to take at your job, let's say?
That's why she's asking whether it's medical prescription.
It's just like cannabis is treated like any other medication, depending on your personal side effects. If you know them, and if you don't know them, side on the cautious side and don't take it while you're working, driving, or operating heavy machinery, to quote the back of every label.
And CBD it works a lot, and a lot of places are acceptable of CBD. These vape pens are making it easier to use and to because I see a lot of people with vape pens nowadays, and you honestly can't tell if it's what's in there. It could be tobacco, it could be whatever it is.
Yeah.
So, at Disneyland in the smoke section, you can. That's a thing.
Yeah.
They won't take you to the Disneyland jail anymore.
No. Exactly.
That's great.
Yeah.
You
exactly.
You can just go to the smoking area, period.
And there you go.
You can vape pen. Yeah. They won't allow the joints. Yeah. You can't smoke blunts or joints or anything there, but they will allow the vape pens. Yeah. So that's cool. We're coming to the end. Thank you so much, ladies. I appreciate your input and your yelling at me and getting mad at me.
Oh, yeah, that.
Thank you for bringing it up.
I hope you guys still are willing to come back, and I hope you guys still love me. Oh, come on.
Always.
Oh, come on.
I get excited. Always.
Tell people where they can get a hold of you.
I'll convince Boo. Come on, Boo.
Alex, where can people get a hold of you at?
Tropical 420 on Instagram and 710 College on Instagram.
And where can they see your speeches or your information on the stuff you do?
Like, all on my Instagram page. Okay. And I've got a link to a recent interview that I did here, in fact.
Okay, with Uncle Tom?
With Uncle Tom.
Yeah. All right. Martha, where can people get hold of you at?
Here. I'm just changing it. I'm sorry. I've been getting random requests.
No way.
And messages.
No,
like, no. Just here. Here.
Susie's on for it.
Here.
She's like, it's
like, I was so for it before. Like, yeah, like Instagram. And I'm just like, here.
That is awesome. That means you know they're listening, bro. You know they're listening, Dre. There you go. They're listening, Dre.
What do they want to talk about?
It was just those random messages like, hi.
Hey, Martha.
Or like with a little heart. Oh. And I'd be like, who are you? Like, no.
Right. I am not trying to suck your dick for nothing in return, but I really appreciate the offer.
That's great.
So from now on, here. Hi.
Did you bring condoms?
Sally, where can people get hold of you at?
You already know. It's already here, bro. Come on now.
Lady Boo, where can people get hold of you at?
I don't even know what to say anymore.
She was so excited for Martha.
I know. I'm just Martha's account, you know.
Martha's account. Follow her. I'll be there, too.
Follow us. We'll put a picture of both of us up there.
I'm Dre Day All Day. You can get a hold of me on www.superaudionetwork.com. You can catch past episodes. You can catch our gear. We have sweaters up. We have hats and beanies and all the good stuff. And, you can check us out. We're still on YouTube band, so you can see us live only on here. And catch the video later on YouTube.com, Super Audio Network channel. This Sunday, we have Jag Show 100th episode. And
wow.
May, we're going to have our first comedy show. So check that out. Thanks, ladies, for joining us. I appreciate all the Super Audio sisters. Thanks to Alex. We're going to take off.
Thank you, guys.
We're going to go watch a soccer game blind and go to the bar. All right, everybody.
St. Patrick's Day.
Hey, did you know when I was a little kid, my brother, what he did was he cut the top off on a glow stick, and he started throwing it on the walls, and that shit got in my eyes, and I was blind for like 30 seconds. Aww. No, maybe like.
Aww. So you do know what it's like. Oh my God.
All I saw was seconds
of your life.
I feel so differently now.
All I saw was neon green. It was probably a little bit longer, maybe like 3 minutes, but it wasn't that long. But all I saw was neon green, and I was freaking out because I was thinking in my head while my brother's telling me, stop crying. All I thought in my head was, I'm going to see green for the rest of my life. And I just remember seeing green, and then eventually went away. Like, it got like.
That's weird. Like, yeah,
that is weird.
I swear to God that happened. Ask my mom. All right.
No, I believe you. It went to your brain. Like, your eyes were okay, but.
Peace, everybody.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. You're cool. And fuck you. I'm out.